It does not get much more beautiful than Blodgett Canyon in the Bitterroot Valley. We have Class A football live on SWX. It's the Frenchtown Bronx coming down south to take on Hamilton Bronx. Welcome in, everybody. I'm Jack Marshall, joined by Max Dupras. And Max, first things first, with the Frenchtown Bronx, led by junior quarterback Brody Hardy. What do Hardy and company have to do if they want to get a win tonight?
Well, Hardy, he is their main ball carrier. He is their quarterback. And the one thing you've got to look for is protecting the ball, both through the air and on the ground. He was a big reason why they beat Big Fork last week, and they're going to really rely on him. With 24 carries last week, 143 yards, you're going to look for him. He's going to be big. So, Brody Hardy, if he can keep it in, they could have a good chance to hand Hamilton their first loss in a long time.
And on the other end with the Hamilton Bronx, it's senior quarterback Tyson Bowder. He played in the state championships for him last year. They've only lost one game in the last two games in the last three seasons, one game in the last two seasons, counting this year. Undefeated, top-ranked team of the state, and he's a lot of the reason for it. We'll have live kickoff coming up next on SWX.
Whatever the weather, elevation, or terrain, the Flathead never disappoints. Get there with Corwin Motors Kalispell. We're the ones on the corner with a bunch of vehicles in our lot. Sedans, SUVs, and of course, big trucks for hauling your toys all year round. Don't waste your time. Get the best price and the best service all in one place. Corwin, family driven for over 100 years. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer. Current lessees can lease a new 2023 Silverado 1500 with the TurboMax engine for $449 a month with $29.95 due at signing.
Health Break is brought to you by Providence.
Providence is using a new type of imaging to better detect the spread of prostate cancer throughout the body. Dr. Robert Frost describes this imaging called PET PSMA.
PET PSMA is an imaging study that's used to diagnose prostate cancer that may have spread elsewhere in the body. And PSMA stands for prostate-specific membrane antigen. Prostate cancer cells overexpress this protein on the outside of the cell, and we use that to our advantage to find the prostate cancer cells in the body.
PET PSMA can find almost microscopic cancer cells in areas that might not have been visible on other imaging studies. This imaging is used for men with newly diagnosed prostate cancer and those with a reoccurrence.
We'll be able to tailor the treatment decisions by the patient's urologist and oncologist to have a better treatment plan for that patient. It used to only be offered at really large academic centers that were usually on the coast. It allows the patients to stay locally, see their urologists and oncologists locally, and be treated locally.
Find out more, visit montana.providence.org.
Health Break is brought to you by Providence.
Welcome back once again to Hamilton High School. This beautiful turf field here, great facility. It's about, I'm saying, four years and a quarter old. They played one game on it 5 years ago. We were talking to head coach Bryce Carver for the Hamilton Bronx. Once again, I'm Jack Marshall, joined by former classmate, co-worker Max Dupras. Max, let's get into the keys of the game a little bit for both teams. Starting first things first, we talked in the open for a little bit, Frenchtown. Obviously a team that only has one win, but their team motto is TNT, stands for, my apologies, I'm blanking out, tough and tenacious, and of course, like you talked about with their quarterback, protect the ball.
Yeah, of course, and that's a big thing is establish a run, and like I said in the open, I mean, 24 carries, 143 yards, four touchdowns. He had 6 yards per carry. You have to let him just get that ball and go. I mean, the quarterback keeper might be your best bet. You can't rely on it every time, but if he can kind of reduce those turnovers and keep the ball in his hand, they really have a chance, and Big Fork's a good team, and being able to beat them, get that first win, that's huge.
And on the other end, we talked about Hamilton. Let Bowder cook. Let him cook. He's been so good for them. And other key to the game, stay hot, man. This team just wins football games in the last couple of years. Obviously undefeated this year, and they're going to be looking to do that again as we got our coin toss underway. Both teams, Frenchtown and Hamilton, two rivals. They're very close here to each other in Class A. Not a lot of turf facilities like this one in the Class A. Obviously, Duke Central plays on one, but that's Montana Tech's over there. Polson has one, too. On this side of the state, Frenchtown plays on a grass field. As it looks like Frenchtown will kick off to the Hamilton Bronx to open up some Class A action. Really quickly, we'll talk about this a little more throughout the broadcast. Class A Southwest standings are a really competitive division with three undefeated teams. That's going to change tonight, though. Two of them are playing each other over in Corvallis. But Hamilton, number one, top of the division. Frenchtown at four. Four kind of sounds like, oh, in the middle of division, but they're behind three undefeated teams. So really had to be a spotless record if you want to be in that top three. So we get ready to kick off. Under the lights.
Colton Zenner for the kickoff for Frenchtown.
Two Bronx back to return there around the 15-yard line. And we are underway on SWX. And it's a squib kick caught quickly, though, by Hamilton. It'll be returned before a few Bronx will jump on top of it. Taylor need the return man, so maybe a bit of a surprise to start the game for Frenchtown.
Oh, yeah, and you got to love that. You got to play a little bit risky, especially when you play an undefeated team. You got to throw a couple wrenches into your game plan, into their game plan, and I think that was that. They did get a decent return, but I love Frenchtown's tenacity. Start big early.
Here comes Tyson Bowder and the Bronx. Bowder yet to throw an interception this year in their undefeated start. 10 touchdowns through the air. First and 10 on the 38. For Hamilton after the squib kick, not a long return. A quick little screen pass, and it's going to be the hook and ladder play to Frederick. Frederick's got space across the 50. And a little trickery for the Hamilton Bronx.
Wow. Now, that was a nice play. And what was I talking about? Throwing wrenches? That was a huge wrench. Look at this great play. Pass to the side. Just dumped off. And bang, Frederick goes off. And he's pushed out. Honestly, great play to get him out of bounds. But that was just a beautiful trick.
Hunter Stort, their lead receiver to Frederick. Their lead running back is a quick pass here. Is going to fall. Incomplete on the turf, right on the Hamilton Bronco logo. That's going to be intended for Lucas Lamb.
Sometimes it's too good to be true. Two back-to-back solid plays. You got to get the kinks out as well, even at home. And this student crowd is looking great right now, and they're loud. They are loud.
Got a great student section out here for Class A Hamilton. Batter going to look out to his left. He's going to find Stort. Stort cuts to his right over the 50. Now with a 40 before two Bronx take him down near first down yardage.
That's a nice play. You got to love that. Stort right here. And, oh, wow, look at that. Yeah, there's a nice little block right there.
Lucas Lant, fellow receiver at the block there. Batter going to go quick handoff. Now it's going to be Frederick right down the middle. So after three quick pass plays, they put on the ground and able to make a dent in the defense.
That's really great. Andrew Frederick, he has been amazing for Hamilton. I mean, six rushing touchdowns on the year. He's even punt slot, 200 yards punting for him. He's versatile for him.
Leads their conference in rushing yards. Andrew Frederick. Now it's going to be Bowder. Dropping back across the Hamilton logo. He'll find Frederick. Frederick out in the space. Makes one man miss across the first down yardage before he's taken down just outside the 20.
Oh, my goodness. Put the foot down and go. That was a great play. You love a little bit of a juke, and we'll look at that right here. He's looking around. Bowder finds his man. Look at that. Oh, and he gets that perfect miss, and oh, my goodness. You got to love that. You got to love a little bit of miss.
Hamilton gets the ball in space to their playmakers. Obviously moving fast on the turf. It's going to be a toss to Frederick. The ball is on the ground. A fumble, but it's picked up by Frenchtown. It's going the other way. The Frenchtown Bronx catch a break. On top of it is Wyatt Leishman.
Oh, my goodness. Now, that was wonderful. You've got to love that awareness as we look at this play right here. Bodder gets it over. Frederick fumbles that one a little bit. It's tipped up. And look at that.
Leishman is looking for a return.
Leishman wanted it. Yeah, you got to love that. You got to love when the D linemen get there and cover that ball. That was awesome.
So Frenchtown gets the ball back after Hamilton was moving the chains. It's a game of turnovers. Frenchtown will take over on its own 22, but a great play as we see Dan Lucier, the coach, on the other end for Frenchtown. He's in his first year for the Bronx. Got his first one of his tenure last week against Big Fork. So here come the Bronx of Frenchtown. It's going to be a QB run by Brody Hardy, and he's caught in the backfield.
That was a great play. Oh, my goodness.
Looked like an Andrew Burrows in the backfield. A big boy there for the Hamilton and Bronx. 6'2", 240, Max.
Man, that I would not want to see that guy running at me, that's for sure. But Andrew Burrows gets right in the backfield. You got to love that. That's just great tenacity and gets through and gives Hardy nothing. And that's what they need to do this game.
Hardy looked like a designed QB run. They're going to go with motion to the right-hand side. Now Hardy's going to roll out to his right-hand side. Now he's going to tuck it and run. He's hit right at the line of scrimmage and taken down by a couple Hamilton defenders, including Lucas Land.
We're going to see a lot of that tonight. Hardy is going to hold on to the ball as you see this play. He's going to roll out, and he gets a little bit of room. When you see green grass, you got to go, and I love that. So Hardy's going to keep with that game plan, and he did it. He did it. We're going to see a lot of that.
Lucas Lant, team leader in tackles.
All right, Bronx,
he's got 35 already this year, now 36 with that last play. And look at Hunter Stewart back there. Second conference interceptions for him. So a big third down for Frenchtown. Third and 12 after they forced the turnover in their own end zone. Kratt getting into it a little bit early. He's going to roll out to his left. He's got some space. He's going to launch it near the sticks. It's going to be just short. Dylan Warner with the grab.
It looks like, yeah, just short. Good. Good little throw out. You know, you kind of got to get rid of that ball, and luckily his guy was there, but unfortunately it looks like
they might bring on the punt unit.
Yeah, that's going to be tough. That's going to be tough, but you got to like that. I think Brody's really trying to get into this one, and you got to get those first couple short passes out before you can really go and throw that long ball.
Lucky, one of two guys back to return for Hamilton. It won't go to him, though. Return across a 30, and he's hit right at the 30. It's going to be Hunter Stewart. And so after a turnover forced by Frenchtown, we got a flag coming in late. Right by the Bronx logo. Looked like two Bronx. Well, both teams are the Bronx, so it's always going to be two Bronx. Got into it a little bit by the end of the logo. Some laundry on the field. We'll see what this is. Looks like Frenchtown is already moving back. Moving backwards, but Max, what a stop by Hamilton. They were driving really well, and then a tough fumble. Those always hurt your team, especially when you're that close to the end zone. But able to force a quick three and out and a punt. And you didn't hear that. It's two unsportsmanlike penalties. So I was right. It was two Bronx. And they offset, so it won't move anyone anyway. Just, you know, no love lost between these two teams, two rival teams.
Oh, no. And you know what? That's what you got to expect. You got to expect a little bit of jarring, but that's kind of what you love, is you love players who are passionate about playing. So that's really great.
Adder and company start on their own 33. First and 10 for Hamilton. A handoff right down the middle of Fedrick. He's met by a few Frenchtown defenders, including Wyatt Leishman. And this will go for a gain of short.
Great wall of Frenchtown comes in and just stops him. That's really what you got to do. Fedrick is a versatile athlete. He's gonna make it hard for you at every level of the field. And if you can stop the run, you force them to pass, that'll be great.
Outer and company going a little quick. They don't do true huddles. Now a quick pass in the flat. It's caught, but taken down after only a short gain. Now some guys are flipping on top of each other. Spencer with the reception on the far side.
And look at that play. Great tackle, good wrap-up. And, well, look at that. Oh, that's the quarterback.
He's riding the Hamilton Bronc over there, man.
Yeah.
Look at that.
There you go. I've never seen that. but Hardy gets that play, and that was a great tackle by him.
Hamilton now, third and six in their own territory. Dodder going to roll out to his left. He's looking for a guy. He's got one. It's caught across the 50. Spencer with the reception. He's going to be driven back, but not after he gets first down yardage, and now a flag comes in.
And that was crazy. Jackson Spencer, he's leading the team in receiving touchdowns, and that's great. Let's look at this play here. Bonner's going to roll out. Nice throw, and just right in that gap. Beautiful play, and he goes. Look at that.
And Spencer obviously a little mad about the end of the play, and they're going to call a personal foul, a late hit on the Frenchtown Bronx, 15 yards after the original play. So a big first down on that last replay. You saw Bowder set his feet and take the hit to make it a more accurate pass, and he hit Spencer right there. That play, as teams are still trying to figure it out, right in front of the bench of Hamilton. So it kind of seemed like the Bronc crew was all over it. Bryce Carver in his seventh year, as you see him strolling the sidelines. Here's Bowder. Quick handoff to Frederick. He's got it down the middle. He'll be tackled by a couple Frenchtown players after a gain of short. Max, he had the fumble in their last drive, but they're giving the ball right back to him.
Oh, and you got to. I mean, Frederick, you saw that play. He's a power runner. I mean, he puts his foot down. He gets the hand out there, stiff arms the guy, and just goes. I mean, look at that. 5'8", 195. He's gonna be that guy that you want to win in the trench, so.
He's on the short side of 7 yards per carry, and he'll get another one down the middle. Across the 10, the 5, the touchdown! Andrew Frederick, touchdown Hamilton.
Oh, wow. And that was a powerful run. You have one with your head down, and then he just starts to get elusive.
We have another flag on the field. This one's back by where the quarterback Bowder started, right at the 20-yard line.
Let's look at this replay. Frederick has a guy miss and gets a great block to just go all the way.
Good vision. Yeah. By senior, or the senior running back, Andrew Frederick, 5'8", 195.
And Lucas Land on that block, too. Land, who has had multiple great plays to set up the running back.
There's our official. He's going to come in. Unsportsmanlike conduct on French down there. The third penalty assessed to the Frenchtown Bronx since the punt that started this drive. One also was assessed to Hamilton. Four total penalties on that drive. But it's just going to be unsportsmanlike. It'll stay 6-0 pending the PAT for Hamilton.
And that's always tough penalties. That's something we don't talk about a ton, but they're gonna be a big thing. If they get three this early, they gotta reel it in a little bit, but you're always a little antsy when you play a rival.
Bowder, the quarterback, went to kick, but it's a fake. He's rolling out to his right across the 10, the 5, and he's into the end zone. A two-point conversion on a fake field goal. The Frenchtown Bronx are rolling. They go up 8-0.
Now, that was great. Oh, my goodness. And you got to love that. You have to love this play. Look at that. Little toss back, and Bodder's got the speed. He gets right around those guys, and even with that tackle, gets right there just over, and that was amazing. You have to love that kind of creativity. This game has already started off so creative. Just little things. The squib kick, trick play, and a little bit of craziness with the fumble by Hamilton, kind of the favorites here. And guess what? They're coming back, and they're saying, hey, we want six, and then we want more. You want that, too. So you got to love that. You got to love that creativity.
And Max Bryce Carver, receiver for the Montana Grizzlies. I know the mentality of a receiver. They like to be tricky, as we see. A recap of our drive here, quick little pass play. Frenchtown was all over that, and his big third down pass, Bowder would air it out, find his man, Jackson Spencer, and then the handoff after a penalty on that last play, all the way into the end zone for Frederick to make it 6-0. But as I was saying, Bryce Carver, he was a receiver. You know, they like it. Receivers don't like to just run the ball and run what some would say is a boring offense. They like to be tricky. So, as we saw there, they had the hook and ladder on the first drive, then a fake field goal on the second drive. I was looking because Gabe Judy's normally the PAT kicker for Hamilton. He's 15 for 17 this year. Obviously, sometimes you see soccer players who are the PAT kicker for certain guys, so you never really know if they're on the road or something, not with their team. But I was like, why is Bowder back there? And I quickly found out why. So they could run the fake. And as we see, the kickoff coming from the 45, Max.
Interesting. We will This will be an interesting one.
And it's after that unsportsmanlike penalty that happened after the touchdown run. It was a dead ball. They're not going to assess it. You can't assess it on the PAT. A kickoff from Frenchtown's side of the field. It's going to be squibbed inside the 10. It's returnable. It's going to go behind the returner. He'll get his hands on it, though. Back across the 10 now. A few Bronx there. Tripped up way back in his own territory. Still on his feet for finally Frenchtown's on top of it. And it looks like we have a fumble. And it's going to be recovered by Frenchtown, though. As we look at the Grizzly disposal and recovery replay, this one was kind of in no man's land, and that's where Cole Johnson found himself. You know, you can only cut back so many times back there. As you see, he gets tackled at the end. The ball does come loose. Good job by Johnson to fall right back on it, though. And it stays with Frenchtown.
Those are tough positions. When you get put in that as a returner, it's always tough. The ball comes past you. You're like, okay, what am I going to do? Am I going to stay back here? Is it going to fall in the end zone? Or am I going to try and return it? And he tried to, and had some good effort.
Frenchtown going to go with a quick handoff here, starting from their own 9. And it is swallowed up by a few Hamilton defenders. Once again, it looked like the big man Lucas Lant was in there.
Looks like Brady Schmill will be the one with the carry on that play.
Brady Schmill with the carries. 36 rushes for 201 yards coming into this game. Also a valuable player on their defense. But, yeah, back-to-back drives for Frenchtown starting in their own 20-yard line.
And that's not the best place to be, but honestly, in games like this, in rivalry games, you try a lot. You try a lot of different things, so you might see something crazy. You might see a crazy pass, so let's look for that.
It's going to be Hardy stepping into the pocket. He pump fakes, and now he's going to roll out to his left. Still on his feet, a quick pass, and it's going to sail over the head of his receiver and incomplete.
And that Hamilton front, that front seven is just tough to get past, and you can clearly see he didn't have a lot of time. He was trying to look around, and he has to go out, and unfortunately that ball didn't land, but that's what happens when you play against a really good defensive line.
Looked like Hunter Stewart, one of the favorite targets of Hardy, was the man on the intended pass. A big third and long now upcoming. Third and 12 for the Frenchtown Bronx. Hardy with his own end zone behind him. He's going to look up to his left. Now his right. It's going to be a high jump ball on the sideline. It's caught. It's caught. Over the top of the defense, Billy Craig.
Oh, my goodness. Jump ball receiver. Look at this one.
Oh.
Hardy goes, airs that one out. Corrett says, no way. Let me have that.
A head tap on third and long on the opposing sideline. Oh, what a catch by Billy Craig. He's third in the conference for receiving yards. Coming to this game, 4 touchdowns, which makes him tied for first in receiving touchdowns for their conference. Now, first and 10 on the 37, a huge conversion. Now it's going to be a sweet play for the Bronx, and it's quickly sniffed out by this Hamilton defense. A few guys in there, including Andrew Burrows.
Well, you got to expect that. They've been really, the Hamilton's been really defending the run super well. The one thing, after watching that deep pass play, throw it more. I want to see more of that. Corrett was great. I mean, listen, you love it. We love it. The bench loves it when they see a guy get mossed and it's their buddy who's doing it. So that's the kind of stuff you want to see, and you want to get your team hyped for moments like that.
Max wants them to throw it deep every play. Brody Hardy out of the shotgun. Goes for a quick handoff here, and it's swallowed up by the defense. How about this Hamilton front line? Oh, my gosh. Hunter Stewart on the tackle.
Hunter Stewart, and he's actually leading the team in interceptions. I know interceptions are few and far between, but 2 picks is pretty good this early in the season, so you got to love that.
Stewart, obviously like a lot of these skill players, a two-way guy, also a really good receiver for these Bronx. And another third and long. This time it's third and 14, upcoming for Frenchtown. Hardy will take it in the pocket. Now he's going to run, and he's going to be sacked. A sack by Hamilton, and the Bronx defense holds.
That looks on the play. I mean, that's as good of a name as that sack was. I mean, I'll tell you that much. That was wonderful. Look at this play. Doesn't know where to go and just follows that man. And it's tough. Quarterbacks are tough to take down, especially guys like that who are super fast. And he did it. Defensive, you got to shout the defensive line right there.
Frenchtown with their second punt. This one will be high and fair caught back by the 24. By Hamilton. So we can see them come back on the field. Hunter Stewart was the man on the punt return. But these Bronx, thanks to three penalties. These Bronx, both teams are Bronx. Thanks to three penalties by Frenchtown, counting Hamilton's punt to them on the last drive, and a really good run at the end of the drive by Andrew Frederick, they were able to go up 8-0 after the PAT conversion was good on a fake field goal.
And that's how you got to play. You got to play fun like that. I mean, Andrew Frederick is just an amazing player. You can see it right here, and they're gonna let him cook a little bit more here. Botter's been great. This is just a dynamic offense, and I'm loving it right now.
They've made it inside the Frenchtown 30 both drives, and here's a quick run by Frederick. He's got space across the 30, across the 35, before he's pushed out of bounds for first down yardage.
I mean, I'm going to keep saying his name all night. He's quick. He gets the edge. And you can see, even when there are defenders right there, even when he gets to the secondary, you're not sure. He takes it, gets a good gap, gets good blocks, and he finds his lane, and he gets it out of bounds. I love that. That's just a smart play. That's a great show of athleticism for that kid. So shout out to him and continuing to push it.
A two-receiver set. Batter's going to pass. He's got a man across the middle, and it's caught over the Hamilton logo. That's Jackson Spencer.
And Jackson Spencer, who his second reception, that was... I mean, look at that. Let's look at this play, actually. Botter gets it right there. Great in the gap. Gets taken out anyways, but two long passes straight to Spencer. He wants that ball.
A quick handoff now to Frederick. He's got space again near the sticks for another 10-yard rush. Frederick averages almost seven yards a carry coming to this game, and that's definitely not going to cut down low. Credit to the Frenchtown defense. They've been in the backfield in the face of Ballier, so why not just draw it down the middle?
And that was a great play. I mean, you got to credit the offensive line. The big guys never get the credit. That gap was perfect for them, so you got to love that.
Clock rolling just above 3 minutes here in the first quarter. First and 10 on the 32. Frederick with another handoff, and this time he's swarmed, and a flag comes in at the end of the play. Frenchtown, good defense there. Brady Schmill, one of two guys who took him down. Max, we talked about the penalties on the last drive for Frenchtown. We'll see who this is on.
That's always tough. Look at this play. Gets the handoff and just swallowed up. Honestly,
sorry. Official throw it in on the left side of your screen there. He's behind the formation, but now the Frenchtown offense. Block in the back.
Number 66. Taking a penalty.
So this time it's Hamilton with the penalty. The official start. We saw on that replay there from behind, a block in the back. And so now it's going to be first and long. Good news for Hamilton, Max, is still first down, not third and long. Their offense has been able to get some chunk plays today as they look at their no-huddle type of offense. They do here, looking to the sideline for the play, is Bowder. Frederick's going to be on his right hip. Three receivers split out right, one left. Right on the Hamilton Bronc logo at midfield. Bowder going to roll back across it. He's looking deep. He's going to throw it deep. He's got a man deep. Touchdown, Hamilton!
Oh, my goodness. How far was he down the field? No one caught him. He was right there. You got to love that. That's James Rawl on the play. That was just a great shot. Botter showing off the arm. I mean, that was a missile, and it landed right in Rawl's hands. Let's look at this play. Botter gets that.
Looks like Rawl's out behind the defense.
And look at that. Just slings it. And what a shot. Oh, my goodness. He comes back to it. Rawl comes back to it just a little bit, but that was an amazing play. And not a lot of high school quarterbacks can make throws like that.
Yes. You watch that crazy sidearm throw. Gabe Judy, the PAT kicker, came on and kicked it this time. Last time we saw Bowder, the quarterback, pretending to kick it. But this time, their PAT guy comes in and puts it up. 15-0 lead. Let's take another look at this one, Max.
Bowder looks, steps, and yeah, just a crazy throw. I mean, the way his mechanics are so interesting, the way he slings it from the side like that, but it doesn't matter. Because he can just chuck it halfway down the field, and his buddy Rawl is going to be right there for him.
James Rawl, the senior receiver and defensive back, slipped behind the defense. Three receivers set to the right side. I guess four total receivers out there, but three to the right side. Ran a nice concept and got Rawl deep on a first and really long, Max. I wouldn't have been surprised if I saw that on a third and long or something like that, but first and long, Bryce Carver called his guys play. What a throw by Tyson Bowder. His first touchdown of the evening. That makes him 11 passing touchdowns on the year. Still yet to throw an interception.
No, and you got to love that. You also got to love the...
Yeah. Gabe Judy going to kick off now. This one is shorter on the 20. It'll be picked up by Frenchtown. Or it's a quick tackle above the 25. So the best starting position for Frenchtown all day. As we look at some highlights from this Hamilton defense, they've been in the backfield early. Obviously, you have a running quarterback like Brody Hardy, but they've sniffed that out and been really good against the run today, Max.
Oh, and it's always tough because we talked about this earlier. I want to see them rely on that run a little bit more, but it is so tough with Hamilton being that good. However, you do got to like that they're throwing it a little bit more, and I like that Hardy's trying to risk it a little bit, and you got to with a 15-point deficit.
Well, the sun went down behind the Bitterroots as now we got a run up the middle from the quarterback, Hardy. So that's a great instant replay look we got from our guy, Cody. That was a run of 7 yards on first down. So best field position of the day for Frenchtown, and they start off with a good 7-yard run, Max.
Oh, and that's great. Hardy is somebody that he's going to do that, and when you give him the room, he's going to go.
Second and short, and a flag before the snap. Looked like there was a little movement up front. I didn't see any defenders jump across the line. And it'll be a false start on Frenchtown. That's on me, Max. That's not a false start on Frenchtown. Encroachment on Hamilton. First
down.
The Frenchtown offense started to move backwards. I thought they were going backwards, but that was usually you have to jump a little farther out or hit a guy or the snap has to move forward and coach him, Max. But there, the hard count gets them, so easier hard. The second first down of the day for these Frenchtown Broncs. So now two running backs in on either side of Brody Hardy. He steps over to the pocket, a deep ball into double coverage, intercepted. A flag comes down to the end, but it's the quarterback, Tyson Bowder.
Oh, my goodness. You know what? You know who's going to see a play like that, a pass like that?
A quarterback.
Look at this. Hardy, he gets some insane pressure here. Look at that, and he just chucks it as he's going down. And Bodder, bang, he says, I've seen a play like that before. I'm going to take this one back.
We'll see what the flag is, and they're calling pass interference on Bowder. Bowder, a phenomenal play in the backfield, but he hit the receiver. Bowder is a guy who has interceptions. He had 3 touchdowns and an interception in a game against Big Fork this year. He's one of a few different guys from this Hamilton team who will probably play in college ball. You get a slow-mo replay there. I'll let anyone at home be the judge if that's a penalty or not. I'm not going to take a shot at it. We saw our official throw his flag up there as Bowder about the play. It's going to be a first down. It's not near the spot of the ball like you see in college or professional. In high school football, it's just a yardage penalty, so it'll be first and 10 on the 44 for Frenchtown. So Frenchtown catches a break, no interception. A run to the outside, and it'll be taken down for a loss. Carter Morgan sniffs it out, and more great run defense from Hamilton.
And that was a great play. Morgan actually leading the team in sacks. We'll get a replay on it. Look at this. Great And you got to track your man. Running backs are always, they're the most elusive guys on the field. So you've got to make sure you can keep that guy in a box. And he kept him in his box and said, I'm bringing you down, brother.
Yeah, Morgan must have put some glue on his hands or something. He was not letting go. And a great tackle for a loss there. Second and 12 now coming up. Two receivers to either side of the formation. Brody Hardy takes the snap. A blitz up the middle. He's going to roll it to his left now, avoiding defenders. He's running for his life now. He's across the sticks for a first down to across the 30, all the way inside of the 25. So Brody Hardy takes the blitz, and he turns on the Jets for a first down.
That was a great play. I mean, Hardy has had some tough moments running the ball, but this is what I'm talking about. This is the athlete that we're talking about. Gets some grass and goes. I mean, he's like a cow the way he sees the pasture. That is beautiful.
Cow when he sees the pasture. Yeah, we're in cow country down here a little bit. I guess anywhere you're not a big city in Montana, cow country. But the beautiful Bitterroot Valley hosts tonight's matchup. Right at the 30 is Hardy. He's going to throw a quick out to his right. He's got a man for yardage and more. So now the Frenchtown Bronx, after giving up that long touchdown, starting to drive into the red zone. Carter Morgan. Oh, no, sorry. Morgan's on Hamilton. My apologies. That's Tanner Waldron for Frenchtown with the reception.
That'll be Waldron's first of the game, and shout out to him. It's always tough when you don't see the ball, but when you get that ball, you got to go. And Waldron really made the most out of his first opportunity in this game, so shout out to him.
Kind of seems like Hamilton using a lot of pressure towards the quarterback and running back, so maybe quick passes. It'll take us to the end of the first quarter. 15-0 lead for the Hamilton Bronx over Frenchtown, but Frenchtown is driving. We'll be back live on SWX.
Hi, I'm Kagan, and at Cars For You, we go the extra mile to put you in a reliable pre-owned vehicle at a fair price. We have a great selection, over 75 to choose from, most under 20,000. All our vehicles are Carfax verified, and we continually update our website so you have current information about our ever-changing inventory. Cars For You is your local, family-owned dealership, and our Montana-grown, friendly sales team is ready to help you find your next quality ride. Stop by Cars For You today on West Broadway in Missoula under the big red sign.
At Stockman Wealth Management, we share the same philosophy of everyday Montanans. Protect what you've earned and plan for the future by creating a path towards financial independence. It's the focus of everything we do. Stockman Wealth Management is your partner in preserving and growing your wealth to last for generations for those you love. Stockman Wealth Management, preserving and growing wealth for better tomorrows.
Even though most banking these days is done electronically, banking can still be a personal experience. At MACU, we are bringing personal banking to everyone in our hometown of Missoula and surrounding areas. When you contact us, you get helpful people who truly care and have the experience to provide the services you need, answer all your questions, and solve your challenging problems. For personal banking, call 728-1034 or visit mtedcu.org. MACU, a credit union for you.
Welcome back to Hamilton High School, where Frenchtown Bronx are driving on the Hamilton Bronx. But a second medium upcoming is a quick handoff fake, bounced out to the outside. A flag coming in before finally tackled down is Brody Hardy. As after that tackle, we'd like to remind you guys that tonight's SWX presentation, high school football featuring Frenchtown and Hamilton, is made possible in part by the Montana High School Association. Wherever you play, the MHSA is on your team.
Max, couldn't have said it better than myself, sir.
And yeah, MHSA has been great all year. We've had wonderful broadcasts here in the state of some really good high school games. Down on the wire games, Bozeman-Gallatin, a good one. That Sentinel Capital game we called. And this one is getting fun as we had a holding penalty at the end of that last play. So it's going to be second and longer for the Frenchtown Bronx. Second and, so it says 10. I got my eyes out. Looks like 11 to me. Brody Hardy rolling out to his right. He's under pressure. He's going to dodge some tacklers across the line of scrimmage before he's tackled. Gain of not much.
That's always tough. He had a really great run earlier, especially when you get those holding penalties. It's always tough to kind of rebound, get your offensive line on the same. And look at this. He's going to roll out, looks for the pass, but doesn't go for anything. He actually gets a really nice juke right there, which you got to love. So even when the play doesn't always go his way, he is still creative and he never gives up. And that's all you can ask for in a quarterback, especially one that has this much ball carrier, vision.
Hardy, third and long for the Frenchtown Bronx, four down territory. Hardy going to roll up to his left. Now he's going to pause. He's going to roll back out to his left, still on his feet. He's going to be finally taken down. Now he's going to throw the ball at the very end of the play, and they're going to call him down on the sack.
And that was a great play. Lucas Lant on that one, it looked like. So you got to love that.
Lant has been all in the backfield tonight. You see Hardy pause a little too long. Full head of steam coming in his Lant flag down. We'll see. Was he down before he got rid of the ball? That one's hard to say.
That's actually Carter Morgan on the play. My bad.
Carter Morgan on the play. As producer's telling us, there's a flag on the play. I don't see one. It looks like it's going to be fourth and long. Fourth and 16 to be exact. They're going to go for it. The Frenchtown Bronx. And now they're going to blow this one dead. We'll see what our officials say. Delay a game.
Offense. Number 12.
Okay. So the official waited until the offense got set and then blew his whistle and called the delay of game penalty on the offense. So now fourth and even longer. Fourth and 21 and a timeout for Frenchtown.
This is not the ideal place to be right now, but if you are Frenchtown, how are you gonna kind of rally your team right here? The coach Dan Lucier, he's gonna have to really say, hey, we're not in the best position. What do we want to do? And they might just go, kick it.
You'd have to have a pretty good leg for high school if you're gonna kick a field goal here.
I don't know.
That'd be 50 plus if you're hitting a field goal from here. The ball sitting on the 37 yard line. Reminder, there'll be a replay of tonight's game on Sunday at 9 a.m. here on SWX. If you want to hear our voices and terrible jokes again, once again, Jack Marshall and Max Dupras reliving this battle in the Bitterroot. Frenchtown with the ball, fourth and 21. Battle of the Bronx in the Bitterroot.
A lot of alliteration.
Battlestar Galactica, Bears. Fourth and long. A quick pass out of the backfield. It'll be incomplete. A turnover on downs, and Hamilton will take over after Frenchtown drove all the way deep into their territory to end the first quarter. Hamilton gets the ball back with 10:44 to go.
And that's always tough. Frenchtown really put a lot of effort into that drive. That holding penalty and the delay of game, it's always tough getting pushed back. And even on a fourth and long, you always hope something can go your way. You maybe hope a lucky break can happen, but it just was not meant to be. And Hamilton, who has been extraordinarily dynamic this night, is going to get another chance to show what they can do.
Yeah, you're right. This Frenchtown team's tough. They start out 0-3, and then last week battled for a first one of the season. Bowder with the ball. He's going to sling it out again. He loves the deep ball, and this one's a little too deep. Looking for an intended receiver on the plays. Hunter Stort trying to ring up another one like we saw in the first quarter.
And that's kind of the beautiful problem of having a guy who has such a great arm. You overthrow it sometimes, and that's all right. I mean, if I'm Bowder, I'm going to throw that ball as much as I can, and it's worked multiple times.
Hamilton, a two-receiver set. Bowder going to hand it off to Frederick. He's fast, and he's going to break a tackle over the 40, where he'll be rustled down for a gain of medium on second down.
It feels like Frederick never goes down on that first tackle. I mean, he had... Frederick, get the... Hardy brings him right there, so that's amazing. What a good play to kind of contain a huge run, but Frederick, he's just dynamic like that.
Keeps his legs churning like a windmill. Bowder on third medium. He'll take the direct snap and run forward, and he's going to be stopped right by the sticks.
That was a... You got to have your conservative runs every once in a while. Frenchtown, they do have their good breaks. They do have a really fun defensive line. They've actually been doing all right. Oh, and it looks like they're actually going to go and...
They're not going to measure this. They're just going to call it a first down on the field. So Chains move. A great play by Bowder there, using his legs to pick up the first down. Right at the 47-yard line for Hamilton. Drunks looking to go ahead. Three scores. Three receivers out to the right of Bowder. One to the left. First and 10. A handoff down the middle to Frederick. He's going to bounce outside and finally draw down for a gain of about 7 across the 50-yard line.
That was another great play as he's coming, walking out. I mean, let's look at this one right here. Great handoff. And, again, those big guys up front give him so much room, and you really have to basically rip his leg off on that play because there's no way he's going down on a normal tackle.
Yeah, great tenacity there by Tanner Waldron from Frenchtown to pull him down. A quick pass by Batter. It'll be caught across the middle by Hunter Stewart for a first down.
Stewart, he's got some moves, too. You got to love that. Juke left, and he gets some open space and goes a little bit more. 6'1", 180.
Got some hair coming out of the helmet, too. I like to see that. Some Rostad brothers who played down here in Hamilton who had a similar thing going for the Bronx back in the day. Quick handoff here down the middle is going to be stopped right at the line of the scrimmage for Frenchtown.
When I think of long hair, Jerry Louis McGee. You got to love that name. And he's looking like it. He's looking elusive. And, you know, he could catch another long ball if Bowder keeps throwing him.
Austin Brash, the Frenchtown defender, with the stop at the line of scrimmage here. So now it's going to be 2nd and 10 for Hamilton. Bowder, running back on his left. He's going to use the hard count. And he got a guy to Frenchtown to jump. Now it's just, we're going to see if someone in Hamilton jumped too. Nope. Encroachment. So now two encroachments next. A lot of times you get a rivalry game or a big game, you know, on TV like this one. Guys get excited. You'll see false starts. But this one, no. It's two encroachment penalties. Good job by both quarterbacks to utilize their hard count.
Oh, and you got to like that. And it just means they're chopping at the bit. I'll tell you that much.
Bowder now with a three receiver set to his left side. You saw him score a touchdown of this formation earlier. He's looking to do it again. It's caught at the goal line by Jackson Spencer for Hamilton first down.
And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Look at this shot. Beautiful, that weird throw, but guess what? Weird is perfect in this play. Jackson Spencer comes down with it. He's clapping. He's saying, bring out the choir because I'm just going to start singing.
Tyson Bowder likes to let it fly like Steph Curry in the fourth quarter. First and goal from the one. It's going to be a direct snap to Bowder. Touchdown, Hamilton.
There's not much to say on here. Good, head down, strong. They're up big, and the crowd is excited, especially the student crowd who, you were saying it earlier, Jack, let's look at this play first, but look at that. Beautiful blocking. I mean, he doesn't even need to try on that play. That Hamilton offensive line has made it so easy.
Bowder, it ran the similar concept as we look at the PAT. It's going to be a low kick, but it's up and through the uprights for the Bronx. It looked like Gabe Judy there, but we saw Bowder run that same play on their third and kind of medium near midfield. Just a direct snap to him. We know he plays defense. He's an athlete. And it worked pretty well for him on the goal line. Obviously, a great long pass to set that up to Jackson Spencer. And Hamilton High School up 22-0. They're rolling. Obviously, 22-0 looks lopsided. Frenchtown has played really hard. They've had the ball on their last drive into really good territory. So offensively, penalty-wise, had some bad breaks. Second quarter, 7:37 to go here under the lights, Max. You know, we know our confirmed location on Sunday, but not sure. You think Taylor Swift could be in the crowd here tonight? We know she's kind of a football fan now.
I mean, listen, if you think the Chiefs are a big deal, come to the Ravalli County, because Hamilton, they're going to put on a show.
They will. They put on a show so far. Yeah, maybe the Hamilton Bronx. Get it done. State champion team. Yeah, once again, two losses in the last 3 years, and they're improving. That's not counting this year. They're also having lost, ranked number one in the state by 406 Sports. And here's the kickoff. It's caught right around the 10, across the 20, the 25, the 30. Of course, a group of, or maybe even a stampede or herd of Bronx converge to start another drive, as we get some good flags running in front of the student section. They're still into it, Max.
Oh, no, and that's great. I mean, yeah, you got to love that. It is homecoming. I remember when I was just up north, actually, at Sandal High School, homecoming went wild. And I'll tell you what, Hamilton is doing just the same.
Frenchtown with the ball, first and 10 from their own 30. Not very bad field position compared to some of the other places they've started tonight. It's going to be a QB run down the middle for Brody Hardy, and it's going to be stifled by Hamilton. Ball came out at the end after the whistle.
And that's always stuff. We were talking about it earlier. Hardy having a lot of those QB sneaks, those QB runs, getting that opportunity. It's been tough for him tonight, but he's not giving up, and you got to like that tenacity. I think he's a kid that doesn't want to give up ever in any game, and even when you're down 22-0, he clearly wants this one, and you gotta love that. Just a leader on the field and probably in the locker room with that kind of attitude.
And Max Hardy, only a junior. This Frenchtown team only has 6 seniors on the team, so obviously something to look out for this year as they continue to grow and progress, but also next year. Now Hardy in the pocket, a quick throw, and it's going to be nearly intercepted by the defender and fallen complete.
Looks like Hunter Stewart on that defense. I mean, he's not a guy you want to throw the ball to either. Like I said earlier, 2 interceptions leading the team, and like I said, hard to come by. So good pass breakup on that play.
Tanner Waldron, the intended receiver. 3rd and long. 11 to be exact for Hardy and the Hardy boys. Frenchtown takes it. Hardy going to step back. It's going to be a quick screen play into the middle. Across the 35 and near the 40 is going to be Brady Schmill. Not quite enough for the first down.
That was a nice play anyways. I mean, let's look at it right here. Brody looks at it and just tops it over, and really great blocks. And even with that blocking, it's tough because that Hamilton secondary was right there. But Schmill, he put his foot to the gas and he went. So you got to like that. Even if it was short, it was a creative play.
Yeah, right, a creative play. Hamilton has brought a lot of pressure, and now the punt units will come on. Looks like Frenchtown's trying to catch Hamilton off guard. Hamilton's punt unit is a near 11-man swap. Frenchtown's not quite as much. And now it looks like the execution of bringing the punt team on late for Frenchtown worked, and Hamilton has to call a timeout. So a little gamesmanship over from the Frenchtown sideline and head coach Dan Lucier.
Oh, and that's great. I mean, football is a lot of the time a game of chess, and you have to be creative with what your play call is going to be, and clearly that play call, switching them out quick, was just too much for Hamilton. So you got to love that, and I think Frenchtown at this point in the game could really use a boost and really get those guys involved, make them feel like, hey, we can keep doing this stuff. We can keep being creative. Let's not stop. And I like that. I like that.
Yeah, you're right. Football, game of chess, kind of makes Bryce Carver kind of like Magnus Carlsen, if anyone out there is a chess fan.
Oh, no, for sure. I mean,
but yeah, so you obviously just kind of want to disrupt kind of his game planning. And that's exactly what they did. Now they're going to keep the punt team on. Frenchtown, though, wants to bring their defense on. They're not going to bring the punt return team on. It's 4th and 3 from the own 37 for Frenchtown. So a timeout. Always got to be careful for the fake punt, and it won't be a fake punt. Obviously, the starting defense is in there ready for it. This one will roll across the 30 all the way down to the 26. So a good punt, bit of a field flipper for Frenchtown. And this Hamilton offense is going to come back on the field next. And they have been red hot outscoring opponents 154-46 this year through 4 games. Obviously going 4-0. Outscoring your opponents in 4 games by 100 is pretty good.
Oh yeah, no. I mean, and we've been witness to a really phenomenal offense here. I mean, sometimes you can see the stats, but until you see, it's kind of a see it to believe it kind of deal. And they've really shown out. This is the first time both of us have been to Hamilton, and it's been an electric environment and an electric football team to watch.
Yeah, beautiful facility once again. Fairly new turf, only around 5 years that's been up. Bowder fakes the handoff to his running back. He's rolling to his right. He's got plenty of space to run. He still wants to throw. Now he'll finally tuck it and run across the 30. Jukes right before he's tackled near the first down yardage.
I love that he had that much time. He was able to kind of get that read on it. And he said, I don't want to run it. Let me pass it. But he had to let it go. And look at that. Look at that play. He runs out, and he just goes. I mean, like I said, he gets a little juke on it. He's just so athletic that he can't decide, hey, I want to throw a bomb down the field, or do I want to run and make a guy miss?
Looked like his receivers were blocking for him while he was trying to pass to him, so he eventually ran. A quick handoff by Frederick to Frederick. He's going to go across the 40 before a couple of Frenchtown defenders hit backwards. Good defense there by Frenchtown. A few different guys in there, including Brody Hardy, the quarterback. So both quarterbacks playing both ways, Max. You like to see quarterbacks play defense.
Oh, yeah, exactly. And you got to look at a lot of guys. When you go to college, they're 9 times out of 10, you're not going to be playing that position that you play in high school. You got to be versatile. And when your tape shows up like that and you are able to transfer over to the college level and play defense, these clips matter.
Bowder, second medium. And we'll get back to that point you just made there in a second. Got versatility of quarterbacks here in the state of Montana out of high school. Second medium for Bowder. He'll hand the ball off quickly to Frederick. Frederick rushes across the 50 for a first down before he's out of bounds by the defenders. But Max, you're right. Guys like the two Rostads who came here, Carson and Tyson Rostads, played for the Hamilton Bronx not too long ago, won some state championships here. Those kids both played quarterback. Here, obviously, a lot of guys do that in the state, but they went to play for University of Montana, and you see it all schools in the state, but yeah. UM already has some quarterbacks that are linebackers now.
Exactly, and it's always tough. The depth chart for the quarterback position is always so shallow, so you got to adjust, and I think they adjusted well.
A quick stop, the boundary is going to hand it off down the middle, but Frederick wrestled forward for another gain of about 70, averages 7 yards a rush, as we said, coming into this game. And it looks like he's kind of doing that tonight, if not maybe a little over seven.
I was going to say, I mean, this game should probably boost his averages, honestly. This has been a really great performance to watch from him. And, I mean, we said it plenty of times, but he's just uber athletic and super elusive.
Second and four upcoming for Hamilton. Bowder going to step back into the pocket. He's under a little pressure. He's going to air this one out. He's got a receiver. It's caught over the middle. Still on the feet. The ball's on the ground. It's a fumble. And it's recovered by Frenchtown. It was caught by Jackson Spencer into the red zone. And then he was wrestled down. The ball came out. We'll see what they rule it. Here's another look, Max.
Bowder, deep shot. Spencer is number one target tonight, and he gets a huge hit. Brody Hardy on the hit. Ball goes down, and Cole Ziegler is the Frenchtown Bronc to go for it.
Hardy looked to be in a little bit of discomfort at the end of the play. Obviously, Frenchtown quarterback, we just talked about playing both the ways. I hope he's okay. Great hit there. Jarred the ball loose. Spencer arguing that he was down, but they're going to march out the Hamilton defense. So, Max, on the first drive of the game for Hamilton, they getting chunk plays, but then they coughed up the ball on a decisive turnover. Same thing just happened on that drive. Really good offense, and then they turn it over.
And that's the momentum you need right there, momentum change.
New quarterback in for Frenchtown. It's Connor Klimble after the injury to Hardy. And a quick run play goes for nothing. Max, Connor Klimble, according to Max Preps stats, he's their backup quarterback. He's thrown only one pass this year, and it went for a 38-yard touchdown. So, odds-wise, stats-wise, not the worst guy to be as your backup quarterback. We see number 8 coming to the huddle there. Interesting, though. We really hope they're starting quarterbacks already. He's getting checked out on the far sideline there, still on his feet. Good to see, but Klimble, the new quarterback. Klimble coming in, and they're going to call a timeout.
And regardless of what happens here in this timeout, if something ends up happening, if Brody Hardy comes back in, whatever that may be, Connor Klimple, he's a sophomore, and he's 6'1", 160. He's a guy who still probably needs to adjust to the offense, but clearly has adjusted well when he's had those opportunities. It's always tough when you're an underclassman to kind of get used to it, but 38 yards and a touchdown on one completed pass, one attempt, that's pretty sweet. So you got to like that, and you got to like the moxie on that kid, and it's always scary. Huge rivalry game, undefeated team, especially when a guy like Brody goes out, a guy who's a year older than you, possibly your mentor. It's always tough to see, but you know what? Those are the times where you shine as the Hamilton Bronx. Their student section is going a little crazy right now for homecoming.
Yeah, and a bit of a trial by fire coming in. Quarterback, only a sophomore against undefeated Hamilton Bronx, but hey, that's how legends are made. Obviously, we hope their starting quarterback's all right, Brody Hardy. Not the typical way quarterbacks go down on a big hit by them. So Klimble going to come in, second and 10. He'll take the snap. He's going to pass this time. He's going to air it out. He's looking for Pater deep, and it's going to be broken up. Good defense there. That was Jackson Spencer who fumbled that long catch at the end of the play with a pass defended.
And I mean, like you were saying earlier, I mean, those long passes might work. And that was honestly a pretty decent pass. You had to come back to it a little bit.
Kind of there for a second. There's a replay of that pass deflection by Spencer. We're kind of looking at the Frenchtown sideline, seeing what was going on with their QB, who was calling on the play. Jackson Spencer once again with the breakup. So now, third and long from their own six. Klimble going to roll out. It's going to be a handoff. Speedy back takes it. He's still going forwards. And this one is for a first down. What a rush. Cole Ziegler got the sweep, Max.
Yeah, and Ziegler, oh, we look at this play right here. Look at that. Yeah, beautiful sweep. Gets a great juke. And honestly, he kept going. And look at him. He's going to reach for it.
What an effort by Cole Ziegler. Hey, third and long, way deep in your own territory. Never back down. Never what?
Never give up, sir.
That's right. Yeah, no, that's good. You're on it. You're on it. Klimble now. Going to hand it off down the middle, and Frenchtown, my apologies, Frenchtown with the handoff is Klimbu had the ball, and Hamilton, some more solid run defense there, Max.
They're going to keep doing that, even with a different quarterback, Ziegler, getting his first carry of the game. You're going to still see the same tenacity from that Hamilton front, but that is all right. You kind of have to work with that, especially with the new QB in. And I think he's going to really have to adjust quick, especially against a team with such a powerful front.
Well, second and 8. They still got 2 yards on that run down the middle by Klimble. Once again, backup quarterback for Frenchtown in the game. He's going to hand it off on another jet sweep here with room across near the first down yard line is Cole Johnson.
Another sophomore to sophomore. That's, we're seeing a lot of young guns come in, and I think deservedly so as we look at this play and a little bit of a, looks like a little bit of a misdirect. Kind of guides that ball a little bit differently, so you got to like that play. Cole Johnson gets it.
Good follow there by our camera operator down low. So that would be always hard to tell when it's a sweep play who's getting the ball. I can't tell up here, especially when you're behind them. But a first down play, they're starting to utilize this sweep. And it's worked pretty well on that long third down in there. So two first downs off of a sweep play. Connor Klimble still in. No sign of whether or not starting quarterback Brody Hardy going to come back into the game. A two-way player for Frenchtown. Just over a minute to go here in the first half. It's going to be a handoff down the middle, and this is going to go for a loss. The D-line from Hamilton strikes again.
And I mean, we're going to keep hammering the nail. I mean, look at this. He just gets swallowed up, and that's all there is to say. Hamilton has really done a great job of defending the run. And we always talk about, you know, establishing the run is a great way to do it if you don't have necessarily, like, the most refined passing offense. But clearly with Klimple, he's a guy who wants to throw the ball. So you want to think about maybe giving him those chances to throw it deeper more. But if you want to keep him comfortable, it's okay to run that ball a little bit. But I wouldn't be afraid to let him throw.
Andrew Burrows, the 6'2", 240 D lineman, in for the stop for the Hamilton Bronx in the last play. We got a timeout on the field. If Frenchtown wants to drive down the field, 55 seconds, running the ball is not the best strategy to keep the clock. It's possible, though, that Hamilton, I didn't catch who called that timeout, Max. Both teams with one left. But Hamilton could also want the ball back and try and score again here before halftime.
And you know what? If you're Hamilton, you want to try and put this one as much out of reach as they're doing a little bit of a something. I don't know. Oh, I think it may have been the roller coaster.
They're riding the roller coaster here in the bitter. Quimble going to take the snap. Second long. Now he's going to air it out. He's got a man in a one-on-one. Coverage is caught across the 50. Now across the 45 to the 40, where he's finally ripped down on the reception. It's his man, Billy Currett.
And look at this play. Klimple, what was I saying? Let that man throw. Unloads. And bang. Correct gets it. Beautiful juke. Makes two miss. And he almost makes a third at the end, but gets caught. Correct.
They're using a little pace now. It's Klimble rolling out to his left. This is a designed run. He's going across the 40. A flag comes in as he's tackled for a gain of short. And Max, they just ran here. Not that one there before. Your favorite play, a jump ball to Billy Correct.
And that's... that's what I was talking about earlier. Look at this play. There's Klimble running to the left.
Yeah, there's the flag comes in at the very end. Lands between the legs there of the big man. Andrew Burrows once again in on the defense. He's been active tonight, and now it's going to reset the first down. This is going to march it back. I think that's holding on Frenchtown, so first and 18, according to the scoreboard upcoming. Klimble with it on his side of the 50. Now he's going to have this one high and over the head of his receiver. So obviously, Max, backup quarterback comes in. Communication is not always going to be perfect there, and looks like not quite on the same page as his receiver.
No, and that's all right. I mean, we talked about this. He's a young guy, and he really wants to show his talents, and he's got a great arm. He's got some moxie. You saw it on that run. He wants to do it all. He wants to show out, and you got to love that. So I'm really excited that this guy gets a little bit of opportunity.
How about the backup quarterback coming in, taking his team in the Hamilton side of the field? Now he's going to hand the ball off. It's going to be a short rush over the middle by, might have been Brady Schmill again, the running back and also receiver. We see him that made a good catch on the sideline. And now this is going to take us to halftime. So, good offense by Frenchtown at the end, but it's the Hamilton Bronx pitching a shutout up 22-0 here in the Bitterroot. We'll be right back with you here live on SWX.
I'm Marta Pierpoint, Executive Director of the Humane Society of Western Montana.
And I'm Michael Frame, General Manager of Denny Menholt University Honda.
As we celebrate 60 years in our community, we would like to thank our business friends, like Honda, for promoting adoption at the shelter and right here at the dealership. Denny Menholt University Honda is one of our most pet-friendly partners.
Come in, say hello, meet our friendly pets, say hello to Sam, have a look around. Thank you, Humane Society.
And special thanks to you, Honda.
Is brought to you by Providence.
Providence is using a new type of imaging to better detect the spread of prostate cancer throughout the body. Dr. Robert Frost describes this imaging called PET PSMA.
PET PSMA is an imaging study that's used to diagnose prostate cancer that may have spread elsewhere in the body. And PSMA stands for prostate-specific membrane antigen. Prostate cancer cells overexpress this protein on the outside of the cell, and we use that to our advantage to find the prostate cancer cells in the body.
PET PSMA can find almost microscopic cancer cells in areas that might not have been visible on other imaging studies. This imaging is used for men with newly diagnosed prostate cancer and those with a reoccurrence.
We'll be able to tailor the treatment decisions by the patient's urologist and oncologist to have a better treatment plan for that patient. It used to only be offered at really large academic centers that were usually on the coast. It allows the patients to stay locally, see their urologist and oncologist locally, and be treated locally.
Find out more, visit montana.providence.org.
Health Break is brought to you by Providence. It's the inventory reduction sale at Ronan Motors, and we have amazing deals on new vehicles all month long. Like this new 2023 Jeep Gladiator, up to $12,000 off. Or this 2023 Ram 2500 with savings up to $8,000. Check out this 2023 Ram 1500, up to $8,000 off. We're offering limited lifetime powertrain warranty on all these cars at no cost to you. Check out our amazing savings during our inventory reduction sale at Ronan Motors. To apply.
Welcome back in the beautiful Hamilton High School, and we'd like to remind you that tonight's SWX presentation of high school football featuring Frenchtown and Hamilton is brought to you in part by the Hamilton School District. Hamilton Schools, dedicated to excellence in education. We talked about some of those beautiful Friday night lights. You only get so many of those in high school. And of course, Max, it's homecoming here. It's just, did you, like, in high school, I mean, were you a big homecoming guy?
You know what? I was definitely a homebody, but homecoming was the way that kind of got me out.
Okay.
And all my buddies would come out. I mean, I don't know what homecoming in Shields Valley looked like for you, but...
I'm going to tell you now, you're looking at the Shields Valley High homecoming king, not going to lie.
Wow.
Not going to lie. But it's homecoming, yeah. Wasn't, not a lot of people to go against for that. I'm not going to say how many. Anyway, but yeah, homecoming here. Looks like two of the players on this Hamilton High team are going for homecoming court. Tyson Batter, senior quarterback, one of those two. Once again, a 22-0 lead by Hamilton at halftime. So probably feeling like you're the top of the world in this student section. You know, a big lead. Good to see your friends on a big homecoming weekend. This Hamilton team has been pretty busy this year, starting out 4-0, as we talked about. And a great performance at halftime right now by the Hamilton High dance team, looks like. They all have the football uniforms on, which is pretty cool. It's a cold night out, but cool they get to rep their team here on this beautiful turf field. We were talking with head coach Bryce Carver for Hamilton, Max. He seemed to be pretty proud of this turf they have here.
Oh, yeah, and we were talking about it with him earlier. I think he said there are only two other turf fields that he plays on. That was Butte Central playing at Montana Tech, and there was Ronan. So you really got to love, even if you're Frenchtown, even when you're losing, you got to love playing on a really nice field. And that's always really exciting. So this is just a beautiful place to play. And this is the first time I've ever seen this field, been on this field. And I'm loving it. And I'm also digging this homecoming crowd. Of course, they're taking a little bit of a break right now. They got a lot more cheering to do once the second half starts. But that's kind of how it is. I mean, oh.
And we'll be right back for some more halftime coverage and highlights right after this.
Injured in an accident? Make Bitterroot Law your first call.
All nurses to the nurses station. All nurses to the nurses station.
Even though most banking these days is done electronically, banking can still be a personal experience. At MECU, we are bringing personal banking to everyone in our hometown of Missoula and surrounding areas. When you contact us, you get helpful people who truly care and have the experience to provide the services you need, answer all your questions, and solve your challenging problems. For personal banking, call 728-1034 or visit mtedcu.org. MECU, a credit union for you.
Missoula County's newest locally owned garbage company is in full swing and ready to handle all your residential and commercial needs. With no contracts, guaranteed flat rate pricing, and exceptional service, Grizzly Disposal makes waste removal an easy and efficient part of the way you do business. We take pride in providing top quality customer service using the friendliest team in the industry. No more going through a call center for help. Our team is right here in Missoula and ready to meet your needs. Reach out to us today. Grizzly Disposal and Recycling, the only bears that should be in your garbage.
At MECU, we provide convenient online and mobile banking options to our customers throughout Western Montana, including Missoula, Mineral, Granite, Sanders, Lake, and Ravalli counties. Visit mtedcu.org today to see all we have to offer, like bill pay, transfers, peer-to-peer payments, and remote deposit capture. And our debit cards come with an app that allows you to turn the card on and off. Go to mtedcu.org right now to find out more and get started. MECU, a credit union for you.
From Montana's farms and ranches, right to your screen. Wake Up Montana is your new home for news from the Northern Ag Network. Watch weekdays at 5:20 and 6:20 a.m. for updates on what's trending and market reports from the team you trust. The Northern Ag Network, weekdays during Wake Up Montana on ABC Fox Montana.
Silence is golden. Talk to Bitterroot Law first.
Cool.
Dinner for tonight's SWX crew is provided locally by Kodiak Jacks. Family owned and operated with two Bitterroot Valley locations, Stevensville and Hamilton. Kodiak Jacks, something for everyone. Once again, great food. Max, I know you had a sandwich and enjoyed it as we break into some highlights here from the first half at Hamilton High School. Bronx up 22-0. Max, tell me what went on here.
All right. Well, Brody Hardy here, he went out later, but look at this play. Just an athletic run, get some open grass, and we're going to see him again. He, when he was out there, was playing really well, and when he had open space, he was able to go.
Yeah. Sorry to interrupt you there, Max. Good. Really good offense from Frenchtown. Just a few third downs they weren't able to execute in. Then you talked about Hardy went out of the game. There was a deep throw by Connor Klimble, the backup quarterback, right before halftime, though. So he proved he could kind of bring a spark to the second half. And then, you know, the Frenchtown defense, Max, they forced two turnovers and had some solid run defenses. Hamilton offense, as we saw, really potent. Here's one of the two turnovers. Fumble at the end of the long play by Jackson Spencer. And the fumble on the first drive, too. They looked really good tonight.
Yep, and here we go, that Bronx offense, and that is Hunter Stewart, and this guy, Tyson Botter, has been everywhere. In addition to his buddy Andrew Frederick, look at this roll out to the right, good play, that weird throw, but guess what, it goes to Spencer, and he gets it. Jackson Spencer has been his number one target tonight, and Andrew Frederick, this is the first score of the game, just a powerful run, and then elusive run, too, he gets it both, and Botter, with the two-point conversion, gets some open space, and right there, just barely makes it. And Botter again, beautiful play up to Spencer again, his buddy, and he goes down, and this is just such a great offense. I mean, every single play, it just looks like it was tailor-made for this pass. And look at that. James Rawl hauls that one in.
Probably the play of the half there from this Hamilton offense. And then defensively, they looked really great. Their D-line all over the place, blitzkrieging guys, stopping the sweep plays. Came out early, set the tone. And so far, allowed 0 points to this Hamilton high offense. We'll be right back with you after this. 22-0, Frenchtown. Hamilton lead over Frenchtown in the Battle of the Bronx.
Whatever the weather, elevation, or terrain, the Flathead never disappoints. Get there with Corwin Motors Kalispell. We're the ones on the corner with a bunch of vehicles in our lot. Sedans, SUVs, and of course, big trucks for hauling your toys all year round. Don't waste your time. Get the best price and the best service all in one place. Corwin, family driven for over 100 years. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer. Current lessees can lease a new 2023 Silverado 1500 with the TurboMax engine for $449 a month with $29.95 due at signing.
When it comes to the feud,
name an office supply a man might use to fix his zipper.
You either nail it.
Paperclip.
Staple, Steve.
Or fail it.
Office supply man might use to fix his zipper.
Several lead pencil clippings.
Family Feud. Weekdays at 3 on Nonstop Local ABC. It might look like it, but this isn't a national production. It's local. It's the people who live here covering the teams that play here.
every sport at every level. Live local sports. SWX Nonstop Local Sports.
It was totally awesome.
We're the coolest men alive.
Totally rad.
Who's ready for jazzercise?
Totally mind-blowing. Magic. It's time to go back to the 80s.
It's about the music, giant hair, and glitter cannons.
Oh, God.
It's time for the Goldbergs.
Weekdays at 3:30 on Nonstop Local Fox.
Mom and Dad, you must be so proud.
We're proud of all of our children.
She has to say that.
You can't run away from me forever.
Just a heads up, this is my good side.
Yeah. Bazinga, bazinga, bazinga.
Ah! Are you trying to kill me?
Weeknights at 5 on Nonstop Local Fox.
Welcome back to River Valley County. Hamilton High School hosts tonight's game. Beautiful turf field. We'd also like to thank Florence Ace Hardware. Florence Ace Hardware is the place for your friendly and local hardware. Folks, on Old Highway 93 in Florence. Drove right past that. I'm going to drive down here on the beautiful Bitterroot, Max, as we get set to look at Class A Southwest standings here. Some really competitive football. Immediate reaction goes Hamilton, Corvallis, Beaverhead, Frenchtown, Stevensville, Butte Central. Looking at that, looking at the team's records, what jumps out to you?
I mean, it's just the sheer amount of, like, top-heavy teams. I mean, we have three teams on here who are undefeated, and it's going to be fun to watch these guys play. I mean, Corvallis, Dillon, and Hamilton, we're already watching Hamilton play great football. Dillon and Corvallis, I mean, both playing tonight, actually, pretty premier matchup. And then Frenchtown, Stevensville, and Butte Central, who Butte Central still looking for that first win. Stevensville and Frenchtown, of course, we're watching Frenchtown right now and hoping they can come back from a 22-0 deficit coming out of half.
Hey, look, it's us, Max. Who would have thought? Well, us. We made it on a TV, but yeah, really competitive AA Southwest. If you want to have a more live reaction to the stats from that game tonight between Corvallis and Beaverhead, you can watch SWX tonight. We dedicate a whole sports block on 10 p.m. news on ABC to high school football scores around the state every Friday. Obviously, this game is also going to have live highlights there on it. If you missed any of the action from the first half here, once again, it's homecoming. We saw a really dapper-looking young guy get the crown. A few football players in there, but none of them got the homecoming crown. But still a great night as the fans going, Max. Just nostalgic right now here in the beautiful Bitterroot. There's some of the homecoming pageantry walking around here. They all got flowers and crowns. Good to see. Good to see.
Oh, yeah, and you got to love it. I mean, homecoming is just like a really fun night for the students. You got to give back to them. They put in so much hard work year-round, and this is just a great weekend and week. They all get to dress up. I remember getting to dress up for my homecoming and getting to do the different themes. So you got to really love that. So this is just super exciting. You got to love it.
Awesome. Well, we will see you guys after this. More halftime as it's a 22-0 lead for the Hamilton Bronx over the Frenchtown Bronx.
At MECU, we provide convenient online and mobile banking options to our customers throughout Western Montana, including Missoula, Mineral, Granite, Sanders, Lake, and Ravalli counties. Visit mtedcu.org today to see all we have to offer, like bill pay, transfers, peer-to-peer payments, and remote deposit capture. And our debit cards come with an app that allows you to turn the card on and off. Go to mtedcu.org right now to find out more and get started. MECU, a credit union for you.
It's the inventory reduction sale at Ronan Motors, and we have amazing deals on new vehicles all month long. Like this new 2023 Jeep Gladiator, up to $12,000 off. Or this 2023 Ram 2500 with savings up to $8,000. Check out this 2023 Ram 1500, up to $8,000 off. We're offering limited lifetime powertrain warranty on all these cars at no cost to you. Check out our amazing savings during our inventory reduction sale at Ronan Motors.
fantastic hit game show is all new.
But that's just cute.
Fox Wednesday, The Con is on with
Pig Casa.
Could it be legit or just phony baloney?
I think it's snake oil.
You feel like Picasso is real?
What do you guys think?
They're all in on this?
See who finds their fortune.
Is it real or is it snake oil?
All new Snake Oil, Wednesday after The Masked Singer on Fox.
Welcome back to beautiful Hamilton High School. Thank y'all for joining us tonight. Special shout out to my homie Mike Faircloud watching out there. He's a good friend of mine. Beautiful night here in Hamilton, Max. We were talking about Hamilton's facility here. It's a wonderful brand new turf. I guess brand new comparatively. It's in the fourth year. They only played one game on it. But with a team like Hamilton that's played in a lot of state championships recently, just how beneficial is it to have a turf field?
I mean, it's great. I mean, you're putting your athletes in a position to succeed when you have the best facilities, when you set them up for success. I think that goes for any level of football. I mean, you look at the college pros. I mean, they have the top-of-the-line stuff. And here at Hamilton, this turf field makes it really great. And it looks great, too. I mean, I would want to play football on this field, even if I was a visiting player. And we want to talk about this. Yeah, the spring game, Montana's played here. So if you get college teams to play on a turf field like this, you're going to have success with your high school team. And that's not to say that they don't know a little bit about playing on grass fields. Not only do they play on a lot traveling around the state, but they do practice on grass, Jack.
Yeah, they do have grass fields so they can practice on whatever they're playing on that week. So, like, if they go play Butte Central on Montana Tech's turf field out there, Bob Greenfield as it's called, they'll practice on the turf field here. But if they're going to go play, like, say, next year when they go play Frenchtown, Frenchtown's got a grass field out there off of I-90. Obviously, super, super nice. And also, weather is an important part. When it comes down the stretch, you get nasty weather in Montana towards the end of the year. That's how it is. And, you know, love it or hate it, that's how it is. And weather can really change a football game. Last Friday, I was over in Helena where I work, and it was a monsoon. And it changed just the entire course of that game that was played out there. This is a little more like a rugby match than a football game. But here, it gets cold, and the cold is going to affect you. Obviously, everyone's from Montana, but you get to play on the turf all year round, which I'm sure these players really love.
Oh, yeah. And it's just nice to see that the school district is able to give back to their students in that way. That's how it kind of works. When you have students who do good work, you want to give back to them, and you give back to them with their clubs, with athletics, and seeing a field like this, you clearly see that they care about their students, which is super lovely. I mean, that's how it felt. That's kind of how it feels across Western Montana, giving back to those students, and that's what we got to love about these local school districts.
And then, obviously, also, not just football, but it helps a lot of other sports. You get, like, soccer, really great, just an all-year sport, just like Montana. Obviously, just like football, my apologies, here in Montana. And then also, obviously, a really great gym here. They do plenty of district state tournaments here. I actually got to play against, I don't want to talk about the game itself, but the vaunted Arleigh Warriors when I was a freshman in high school here at Hamilton's gym. They host plenty of basketball games and tournaments here. It's a really great gym. They have two gyms they can play in. They have a civic center or an elementary school, I think it is, that they can host two different games at one time. And obviously also a beautiful track wrapping around this facility here. Also rubber, I guess I don't know what the official term for the surface is, but it's definitely not dirt, right? And that's a really great facility. Really nice to be here. Great setup for TV. It's been a beautiful night in Hamilton. We see the moon out as Frenchtown will receive to start the second half. They're down 22-0, Max. Currently the second half, something to keep an eye on. We saw Connor Klimble come in at quarterback after starter Brody Hardy was injured.
And that's a big deal. I mean, Brody Hardy clearly putting in a lot of work early, but Klimble, when he was playing, he had that really great pass to Corette, and that kind of sparked a little bit of a turnaround, but we'll have to see how well that's gonna translate here. We saw Coach Dan Lucier talking to Brody Hardy actually on the camera, which was a great look, and we'll see who comes out for that.
We'll see who comes out. Hope guys are feeling good. Hamilton set to kick off. It's going to be Gabe Judy, their PAT guy. He's been on the field to attempt every PAT except for the fake. And this is going to be a squib. It's going to be fell on, jumped on by Frenchtown. Fumbled for a bit, but they retained possession. So wind's starting to come in here. It's definitely not getting warm at night this time of the year in Montana, Max. We're in a cozy booth, so we can't complain. This is going to be first and 25. And it looks like they're going to bring out Klimble. the backup quarterback, Frenchtown, obviously down 22-0. Really hope the starter's okay if you get through halftime. He's not still out there. Klimbo with a quick handoff down the middle. This one will be bounced outside, but quickly swallowed up. Judy on the carry.
I think that looks like it was...
Oh, my apologies.
Brady Schmill.
Yeah, keeping me on my toes here, Max. It's Brady Schmill. Judy's 13 on the Hamilton Bronx. Apologies for that, but Schmill, running back, also had a few big catches for them tonight.
And Schmill's been holding a lot of ground here in addition to Brody Hardy when he was playing. Schmill has gotten the ball a lot. Those carries really matter to a guy like that.
Klimble in the shotgun, second long. The backup quarterback rolls up to his right and quickly looks for a receiver. It'll fall incomplete in and out of the hands of Tanner Waldron.
And Klimble's going to look to pass. I mean, we saw it earlier. We talked about it earlier. Before this game, he only had one attempt, one completion, 38 yards, and that was a score. So we're going to see a little bit. I'm expecting to see a little bit more passing in the second half, not only because they are down, but because it seems like a guy who is pretty trigger happy.
We're going to go glass half full. Good for the backup quarterback if he's going to be in anyway. Plenty of experience and a great defense to do it against. Hamilton Bronx, it's in a shutout once again. Klimbo back in the pocket on third down. He's going to let this one fly, and it's going to go over the top of the head of Billy Corrett.
And just like Bowder, Klimbo loves to chuck that ball. And when you have a quarterback that likes to throw it and feels like they can get those balls, sometimes they're going to overthrow it a little bit. But you got to love that. That's moxie. And you love moxie in a quarterback. Never give up because you miss a pass. Keep going. Expect the next one to go.
So, quick three and out for Frenchtown. Lubke and Stort back to return for Hamilton. Fourth and 10. The ball back on their own 24. It's going to be punted. This one's going to be low. But it's going to roll a favorable Frenchtown bounce inside the 30. A great punt. Did not go very high, but it kept rolling inside the 30. Not returnable, too.
I mean, you got to like a little love for the special teams. I feel like we don't talk about them enough, but there have actually been some really fun special teams plays. I mean, we saw a couple of great kicks by the Hamilton.
And a fake field goal.
So... You know, those plays on special teams, I mean, it's the first team to come out every football game. You got it. They're the ones who start the momentum, and if they do something fun, then that makes the rest of the game that much better.
First drive of the second half for Hamilton. Bowder going to hand it off to Frederick down the middle. He has saw plenty of action in the first half. He will take this run across the 30.
That was a great stop by Frenchtown right there. Frederick, who is we've seen is can be elusive. He's a hard guy to tackle, but that Frenchtown front stopped him. And they've done a pretty good job in those moments. And if they can keep that up, that could be really great for this second half turnaround if they can amount it.
I would agree. Frenchtown's defense has been stingy. Bowder rolling out to his right. He's still running near the first down marker. First down guy did not want to get ran over. He laid his chain down pretty quickly there, so it was hard for me to tell how close that was. They're going to mark him. Well, should go to the first down. But, yeah, you talk about this Frenchtown defense. Their kind of formula has been bend, don't break, kind of get – let's Hamilton's got some chunk plays on them, but they have forced two turnovers as we check out our Grizzly and Disposal Recycling replay. Bowder, see, tackled out of bounds there. Third and short. A quick handoff to Frederick. He's got the first down across the 40. And more.
And Frederick, he's gonna get those plays. I mean, it was just bound to happen. That's always the tough part. You can play great defense, but sometimes it's like a immovable object, unstoppable force kind of deal. And Frederick kind of feels like an unstoppable force right now.
Speedy back for sure. They're gonna rotate him out. First and 10 for Bowder. Two receivers on either side of the formation. He's going to do a quick little screen play outside to Stort, who's going to catch it and move the ball towards midfield.
Hunter Stewart, who's we've talked about it plenty. He is versatile. I mean, I'm going to mention it again, two interceptions, leads the team. And he's had some really great plays as we look at this replay. Good pass by Bowder. Gets almost the exact. He had a similar play where he gets that juke and kind of puts his hand out and gets some extra yards on it.
and also some great hair. Now a tunnel screen going to come across. It's going to be completed to Spencer. It's across the Bronc logo for another first down.
Now, if we're going to talk about anybody who's been getting the ball a lot through the air, it's going to be Jackson Spencer. He has been the number one target, and for good reason. Let's look at that. Great play, and Spencer, he is just a reliable wide receiver. He just brings it in, and he always gets a couple. There's always a bit of run after catch action with him, and you got to love that.
Great tunnel screen. Offensive linemen were down the field. Now, a quick little play, and it's going to be another screen pass, and he's going to make his defender, Hunter Stort, across the 10. Touchdown, Hamilton Bronx.
And he's scoring just like Jerry Louis McGee with the hair flowing out of his helmet. What a nice run down the sideline for Stewart.
Hunter Stort with the lettuce coming out of the back of the helmet to put Hamilton up 28-0. Another quick screen play. Came into this game second in the conference in receiving yards. And here's another look.
Look at that. He doesn't even really need blocks. He's just so quick. He gets out just a good hole, and he goes. You got to love that. The hockey player, it looks like. He might not play hockey, but he should.
He's got the hockey hair as Judy comes in for the extra point. His pick will be up and good. So Hamilton High in their first drive into the second half. Takes it across the 50, and a long passing touchdown to Hunter Stort. Let's hope some go up 29-0. Over their fellow Bronc, Frenchtown High School.
And this has just been an offensive masterclass by a really good team, Hamilton. I mean, you don't have an undefeated record for nothing, and it shows right there. That offense is just so dynamic. I mean, everybody. Jackson Spencer was a part of that drive. Andrew Frederick getting those long runs. And, of course, Hunter Stewart closing it out. And you can see hair flowing in the wind. And this wind is kind of blowing right now. So it was extra. He was going with he had a little bit of drag on him as he was going.
Yeah, wind in his hair. Great look there. Hamilton now going to kick off to Frenchtown. Hey, Frenchtown came out and battled in the third quarter. Backup quarterback still in. Is the VAT kicker Judy going to come back in for the kickoff here? This will be a kick to the right side. It'll be short and return across the 30 to the 35 to the 40 to the 50. He's got space all the way to the other 30 before finally pushed out of bounds. I think that's Cole Johnson, and a flag flies at the end. So Frenchtown, an electric play on special teams.
Well, I'm speechless. We had back-to-back big plays. Let's get a replay of this one. Look at that. Cole Johnson gets that. And look at that. He gets an edge, gets a hole, and he goes. Look at that. And honestly, like, almost beats those guys. Hamilton's fast, but Cole Johnson made the most of that.
Yeah, he's electric like a copper wire by a power line. Cole Johnson. I love watching punt returners. A great shot there. Selby down low. On that, love that low angle punt return when they're coming back towards you. Always so fun to see a guy who's fast like him, and it's going to be on Hamilton. So first and 10, a drive start in the red zone. Can't ask for much better than this to be the Frenchtown Bronx. It's a quick handoff. It'll be a sweep inside the 5, still pushing near the goal line. Or it's blown dead. That was to Johnson again.
Cole Johnson. Cole Johnson has been the guy. I mean, you gotta love that. Let's look at this replay right here. Johnson gets some good blocks and takes a head on and gets a yard or two after on that tackle. So you gotta love that.
So second and goal from the 3. They're feeding the hot hand. Cole Johnson, a great kick return. Sorry, I said punt return. It was a kick return. And now another sweet play. It's gonna be faked and it's gonna be down the middle. Right near the goal line, Klimble, the backup quarterback. And they're going to mark him just short.
That was a great play, too. Just get closer and closer. And
my apologies, Max. It wasn't second goal. There was a yard gain. So now it's first and goal from the 1. So there was a first down, and it was about at the 1-yard line.
That's even better. You get a reset your downs. I mean, now you have another couple chances here.
Klimble coming in and split backs. Cole Johnson off to his left. It'll be a QB sneak from short range. Klimble pushing the Hamilton defense, pushing back, and they're going to rule him short.
And that Hamilton front continuing to stuff the run, and they do it right there. It's going to be tough. They're going to look to run it here. this goal line package is definitely going to be set up to get probably Klimble in there, but they might have to think about switching it around and doing something tricky.
Yeah, Hamilton front has been so good. Now Klimble in the shotgun. It's going to be a sweet play handed off. It'll be Johnson. Touchdown, Frenchtown. And a flag at the end of the play. Johnson letting them hear it after Frenchtown breaks the shutout. Johnson with a great punt return and then the touchdown. Or kick return. My apologies.
Let's look at this play again. Johnson, nice blocks. Takes a bit of a hit there by Bowder. And there's a little bit of talking. Oh. And that's a slap by the QB.
Obviously the officials are right there. They're, good job splitting up both teams. Jimmy Johnson was excited. He had a great kick return. He scored the touchdown. Letting the Hamilton defender hear it in that. That was a slap, Max. That was Will Smith of the Oscars.
I'll tell you that much. That's for sure. I mean, it's always tough in those moments. These rivalry games get chippy. I mean, we've all experienced a rivalry game, even if you're on the sidelines or in the stands. But one thing you can say right here, let's look at this again. And
talk to him. A little smack. You know, it's football. They're tough. They have helmets on. You know, obviously, both teams separated. Funny to have emotion, but obviously, we want to keep it. During the game, Max. Yeah, you can play hard. They're calling personal fouls on both teams.
There are two ejections.
And Cole Johnson, who scored that touchdown, Max, ejected from the ball game.
And Tyson Bowder,
the starting quarterback. He was the one with the slap. Did you get another replay? So we're down to both backup quarterbacks now, Max.
Wow.
Bryce Carver cannot believe it. And backup quarterback is warming up on the Hamilton sideline.
That is tough.
Carver, I don't think I've ever seen anything like this, Max. Taylor Need is the backup quarterback warming up for Hamilton. So what was a 29-0 lead, still pending a PAT, turned into, it's still a third quarter, 29-6 pending PAT, so not anything crazy. Both teams on their backup quarterback. One just showed they could score with their backup quarterback. Hamilton's senior quarterback, Tyson Bowder, has been ejected for slapping another player.
And you know, like, those moments especially, as this PAT goes.
It's blocked.
Wow. And it was blocked. I mean, even with kind of a crazy play at the end of that touchdown, Hamilton continues to roll.
And I really haven't seen anything like that. It's a great block up front. Looks like that. Andrew Burrows, he's been all over tonight. I think Ben Alexander caught it. I don't know if you're allowed to return those or not, Max. They blew it dead. But, we're talking about this. So, if you're just tuning in here, first half, Frenchtown starting quarterback Brody Hardy, a junior, made a really good hit that forced the fumble, but left the game through halftime, has not came back yet. On the other end, Hamilton starting quarterback Tyson Bowder. He's been great all night. Plays both ways. Plays on defense. Frenchtown scores a touchdown. It gets chippy at the end. And as you saw, thanks to our great replay crew, slap Johnson at the end of the play. Both players ejected. Johnson obviously talking to him. A lot of jawing going on. But he was ejected. So we're down to the backup quarterbacks. Some Class A football. It never ceases to amaze in the Bitterroot, Max.
No, and I mean, Chippy is as Chippy does, and those are the kinds of things where it doesn't just happen in the moment. It has to build up. This has been tension that's clearly been building for a while, probably this whole week for him, so that was a big deal.
In the Battle of the Bronx, there's no love lost. A kick will roll, and it's going to be returned by Lubke, and he'll get hit right at the 15, so Frenchtown with a renewed sense of rivalry after the double ejection with a great play on kickoff. And now, Max, we're going to get our first look at the Hamilton backup quarterback.
And this is honestly, it's tough to have your starter go out, of course. But it is always exciting when you're the backup and you get to say, hey, I get the reins, especially in a big game like this. So
And I don't know what the direct rules are for high school, but Out is still hanging out on the sideline. Obviously, just can't play in this game. Teammates come for him over there. So, first and 10 for Hamilton, deep in their own territory. A backup quarterback in. A quick hand up to Frederick. They still got him in this game, but he's going to be sworn down. The ball going to come out at the end of the play. Blown dead already. And it was Brady Schmill on the tackle for Frenchtown. Once again, quarterback for Hamilton now. Backup Lucas Lant, 6'205". He's listed as a tight end linebacker on the roster. He'll hand this one off to Frederick again. He'll bounce outside. He's going to be pushed forward after a good game. Bring up third and short.
And they're going to rely on Andrew Frederick a lot right now. Without having the same kind of arm that Bowder brought, you're going to have this guy come in. And Frederick has managed to do great as we get a replay. And look at that beautiful juke around. Get some good blocks. And he's going to have a good time. He's going to have a lot of carries for sure.
Lucas Lant is a senior. As we're going to get a handoff, a jumping play. And it's enough for a first down on us. That wasn't a handoff. That was a Lucas Lant. He just ran forward. So the backup quarterback can still run the same plays Bowder can. As we see, yeah, Lant just took it forward. And a hurdle. Ooh, look at that.
And that was awesome. You got to love that, a little bit of athleticism. And that's the best part, is athleticism transfers to either side of the field. So as long as you can make those plays, you're going to help your team.
I don't think I've ever seen a backup quarterback coming and hurdle someone, Max. Lucas Lant takes a snap, hands it off to Frederick down the middle, and he'll be hit at the line of scrimmage. Great defense there from Frenchtown. It's going to be a tackle by Billy Corrett. Our receiver.
Corrett has had some great catches now. It's a little bit of action. Tackling.
Lant, still a senior. Snap's going to go over the top of his head. There's four guys there on the tunnel screen. He'll just jump on it back inside the 20. Hamilton was going to run a tunnel screen, so they left all of the O-linemen, and the snap over the top of Lant's head. So it was a four-man rush. Smart play to jump on the ball there.
And that's another thing. When you have your backup quarterback in, sometimes there's some miscommunication. That's all right. That's what happens. Those growing pains, especially having to make this adjustment so quick.
You don't usually coach for what happens when your backup quarterback comes in, as Lant's going to take the snap. Roll up to his right, third and long. He's going to have this one out. It'll be intercepted across the 40, and Frenchtown forces a turnover. Who else but Leighton Sears?
That's the first time we called Sears' name, the 6'3", 185 junior. That was amazing. Oh, my goodness. Lant gives it kind of a rainbow, but Sear stretches out. Let's look at that. That's great. Look at this rainbow throw, and wow. Well, he dives for it like he was a receiver, too.
So the other backup quarterback is going to come back onto the field. Connor Klimble helped lead a drive that started inside the Hamilton red zone after a good kickoff return for a touchdown on the last possession. He's going to take out to the right, but they're going to blow this one dead. Max, back to that interception. Backup quarterback comes in. Obviously, there's some coachable things about being a quarterback. If it's third and long, and it's a false start here. If it's third and long, you're on your own side of the field. Obviously, you want to minimize the damage, especially after that snap that went over the top of Lant's head. Maybe throw it away if you don't have anything. Instead, throws an interception and gives Frenchtown good field position, but they get the false start. Klimble in the shotgun at the Hamilton logo. He'll fake the sweep. He'll just keep it. Hanging out to his right side, and he's going to be hit hard at the line of scrimmage. And that's going to be Trevor Lewis, whose helmet comes off at the end of the play. It's a tackle for a loss, and Lewis will have to go out for another play. Max, what do we happen here?
And we're going to see this, holding the ball. Lewis gets that down. The helmet comes off. That's a strong play. And he kind of gets in his face. Another chippy play. And you got to see, you do not want another ejection.
That's a good teammate right there, keeping your guys away from, another. We already saw one ejection. Obviously, two ejections. Cole Johnson was just doing talking, didn't do anything physical, and he got ejected. So these refs keeping it clean, as it's going to be a handoff. And now a pass, and he's got a man downfield. It's caught! Dylan Warner, touchdown, Frenchtown!
What a play! Oh, my goodness. That was amazing. Creative.
What have we been saying all game? Stay creative.
The handoff to Bailey Corrett. Face out the camera person. Wait, there he is. And look, a deep pass to Dylan Warner. Frenchtown was down 29-0. And after a kick return, a double ejection, an interception, a sweep pass play, they're lining up for a PAT on what could be our 13-0 run.
That was amazing as it goes up.
And good. Last PAT blocked, but this one is through the upright. So now, home coming in the Bitterroot. Let's take another look at this one. Bailey Crett, the lefty. Southpaws it down inside the red zone. And Dylan Warner celebrating a little bit. There wasn't a camera on that side of the field. If only I was on our right side. But the Frenchtown Bronx, thanks to me, some big plays, some tricky plays, some good special teams are back. And now, Max, Hamilton, Tyson Batters, your senior quarterback, played in the state championship last year. Been in this program that's only lost two games in the last three seasons, not counting this one. Gets ejected. Backup quarterback comes in. Not only do they go three and out, but on the third play, they throw an interception. So now, still the third quarter, a lot of football left to play. Frenchtown with all the momentum. How will the Bronx of Hamilton respond?
You'll love to see it.
Two guys back to return for the Bronx. Lepke on the far side. There's the kick. It's going to be high, and it'll be caught at the 15. Return across the 20, the 30, not quite to the 30. I spoke a little soon. I think that was Hunter Stort back there in the return. Oh, I get the ball. All right, about at 29, Max. What are you saying to your team if you're Bryce Carver right now?
Stay level-headed. We saw one player get ejected. We saw a replay of another guy shoving a little bit. But you just got to stay level-headed. And when you're the adult in this situation, you have to say, hey, guys, we got to reel it in. We just got to be calm. It's all right. Stay calm. We have the lead.
Lucas Lant, the senior backup quarterback, takes the handoff. He's going to run up to his ready. He's caught and dragged down from behind. A great tackle by the Frenchtown Bronx. I think that was Billy Corrett.
And we have two Correttes making big plays. Corrett has had multiple big catch.
Billy is Billy and Bailey.
Billy and Bailey. Yeah. It'll make it easy on you. But Billy, who's had some really big catches, has also made a couple tackles in this one. And then Bailey, who had the crazy pass to score the second TD.
Second and seven. Lant, a high snap again, but he catches it, hands it off to Frederick, and he's swarmed in the backfield for a loss. The Frenchtown Bronx defense has come alive.
It is alive. I mean, much like Frankenstein's monster, look at this. Oh. Boom.
And it's Tanner Waldron in the backfield. And Max, back-to-back funky snaps. We watched him. There's center Warren off. He had a few low ones when we were talking to Bryce Carver. This one's going to be high and over the top of Lant. Back-to-back possessions. That's back-to-back possessions with that same exact play, a high snap, Max. This is what, I mean, you can't blame that on the backup quarterback coming in. I mean, cadence will change. Stance will change. It's but back-to-back high snaps. And now they're going to bring a different long snapper from their center. Andrew Burrow is going to be the long snapper. Fourth and long from their own 14. Hamilton, they're going to kick this ball. And pending, it's a two-score game. Ball caught at the goal line of Hamilton. It's a high punt, not very far, and it takes a Frenchtown bounce. Max, that was a punt of about, with, I don't know, the wind in the air and the spin on that ball, 8 yards.
That, if everything could be going right for Frenchtown right now,
it is. Yeah.
The only thing that what didn't go their way was that PAT, and that was tough. That's just a tough one. When you get a guy that's that big that can get up there and block it, that's what's going to happen.
So the Frenchtown is a touchdown, a PAT away from making, or a two-point conversion away from making this a one-score game. after going down 29-0. First and 10, and they couldn't have better field position from their own 23. It's going to be a high pass, 1-1 in the end zone, a little too high. Well, the Bronx are looking to capitalize even more. Billy Crett, and we have a flag.
Wow.
In the end zone. Whoa. Pass interference on the offense. Okay, on the offense. Look at, all right, get another good look at this one right in front of our camera person. Crett pushed off. Yep. Great call. We had a great look at it. Good job by Selby, keeping us honest down there. So now, rather than first 10 from the 23, it's going to be first and long from the 38. Max, I was never proficient in mathematics. 23-38, what's the difference between that? Is that 15?
I think just about.
Just about.
We're both journalists. We're not good at math, as you know.
We have to take one class in college for math, as it's going to be a quick handoff for Frenchtown. This will be swarmed right at the 40. A quick handoff to Brady Schmill.
Schmill, another guy who, with Johnson being out, who was the guy to score that first touchdown for Frenchtown, Schmill is going to end up filling in for that if he wasn't already doing enough already.
So second and 28. Obviously, if you're Frenchtown, four down territory from their own 40-yard line. The backup quarterbacks are in for both teams. That's just how it's been tonight. Now a deep pass, one-on-one. This one's a little too far and almost intercepted. Ben Alexander for Hamilton was back there. Connor Klimble, once again, the backup quarterback with the pass, and now it'll be third and long.
And, I mean, at that point, you do kind of have to pass it. I like that play call. It's always tough when you throw it a little over, but, you know, again, growing pains, he's a sophomore. I love the moxie. I am a huge fan of the passer, so just keep throwing it, honestly.
Just keep throwing it. So, third and 28. 1:05 left in the third quarter. Frenchtown with the ball, driving, already on a 13-0 run. A quick rollout pass, and this one's going to hit the sidelines. Connor Klimble, Frenchtown's backup quarterback, coming in after an injury to Brody Hardy. Throws this one out of bounds, and Max, I said it's fourth down territory, but it is fourth and 28.
And, you know, that's what happens. He was trying to throw that ball, and those are the kind of hit-or-miss plays where you throw it a lot, you never know which one's going to land sometimes, but you got to really like that. I still appreciate that what he's doing is trying to keep this offense alive and keep them active, and that's a really brilliant part. So shout-out to him. I think he's doing really great filling in for a guy who means a lot for this team, and he's filling big shoes, and you got to love it.
So Frenchtown ball in the Hamilton 40, fourth and long. They're going to punt it. Punter standing right at the Bronc logo. A battle of field position now. This one's going to bounce into the end zone for a touchback. So, Hamilton, Max, we were saying they got just about as many bad bounces as you could. They allowed a long kickoff return that led to a short rushing touchdown, and then their starting quarterback and defensive back was ejected. And then their backup quarterback, after a high snap, threw an interception, and then they allowed a touchdown on a trick play, and then another high snap led to a really bad field position, but they bounced back, got a stop, and got the ball back. Let's see how the quarterback center duo does here. High snap, Land able to grab it. It's going to be a quick pass to their guy, and look out, he's got a wheels. It's Hunter Stort for a first down yardage.
And I think that was Lance's first completion under center.
I think it might have been. They didn't throw the ball in on his first drive. Second drive didn't go the best, but he found Hunter Stort. A good guy to find. So first and 10 now. A renewed set of energy. A quick snap to Land. He's going to run the ball now, and he's caught in the backfield quickly. Tanner Waldron takes him down for a loss.
And this Frenchtown defense is still, even after that pass play, still hounding the ball carrier. And we've seen that from both teams. Both teams have really done a pretty good job of protecting the run. I know we've talked about Andrew Frederick being really elusive, getting some great runs, but honestly, Frenchtown has done a good job of neutralizing him in the second half, in addition to protecting against Lucas Lant, who clearly is going to run the ball a lot.
And the clock will now roll down at the five mark. And it'll be interesting to see how this fourth period plays out. Hamilton and Frenchtown, a battle of the Bronx in the bitter. Hamilton leads 29-13. Both teams' backup quarterbacks are in. We'll be back after this.
It's the inventory reduction sale at Ronan Motors, and we have amazing deals on new vehicles all month long. Like this new 2023 Jeep Gladiator, up to $12,000 off. Or this 2023 Ram 2500 with savings up to $8,000. Check out this 2023 Ram 1500, up to $8,000 off. We're offering limited lifetime powertrain warranty on all these cars at no cost to you. Check out our amazing savings during our inventory reduction sale at Ronan Motors.
Even though most banking these days is done electronically, banking can still be a personal experience. At MACU, we are bringing personal banking to everyone in our hometown of Missoula and surrounding areas. When you contact us, you get helpful people who truly care and have the experience to provide the services you need, answer all your questions, and solve your challenging problems. For personal banking, call 728-1034 or visit mtedcu.org. MACU, a credit union for you.
When you start to see your skin age and signs of aging, Rosalie is the person to help. Free consultations, her menu of services is extensive, and the treatment options are amazing.
Welcome back to Hamilton High School, where we're approaching the third quarter. We've had some fireworks tonight, ladies and gentlemen. First touchdown of the night, as you see Cole Johnson for Frenchtown march it in. And then look, Tyson Bowder with a slap. Both guys would get ejected as we're back here live at Hamilton High School. A quick play from scrimmage to start there, but that's Andrew Frederick, a short run. But Max, what do you make of that?
I've never seen something like that before.
I don't think I've ever seen someone get ejected from a high school game who wasn't a mad parent.
Exactly. I completely agree. And as a graduate of Sentinel High School, we had plenty of mad parents.
No way. All right. Third and medium upcoming. Lant, the backup quarterback in for Hamilton after, as we just saw, their starter still on the sideline supporting his team, senior starter, but was ejected. No love lost in the bitter. Quick snap. Lant going to roll out to his left, and he's going to be swarmed by a bunch of Bronx and white jerseys, that is.
It looks like Billy Collette was the one to get the initial tackle on it.
And another snap just outside, and Billy Collette hawked that one. And now another punt for Hamilton. Frenchtown down two scores. 29-13 game. Clock on the side of Hamilton. Obviously, 10-15 to go. Clock still rolling. We'll see what Hamilton has drawn up here. Fourth and long. On their own 34. Here's the punt. It's fumbled. And it's going to be picked up. It's going to be scooped. And Frenchtown flips the script again.
Are you kidding me? This game can't get any crazier. Look at this.
Xander Mawa. The snap was low. Frederick, the punter, the running back. We saw two high snaps on each of the last two Hamilton drives. And, oh, man. This is about the third straight drive that Frenchtown is starting inside the 30 of Hamilton. First and 10. Connor Klimble with the sweep play. It's going to go around the end and caught around inside the 10 is a Bronc who is now going to go down with an injury. Hamilton student section get into it.
Max, we already saw, once again, starting quarterback for the Frenchtown Broncos. Did we get another look at that punt block? Mauer almost got him out of that scoop and score there. Great job by him.
The first time we called his name, too. Maua.
Special teams, man.
That's where it counts, too. You start on special teams. That's how you get those starts on defense.
Frenchtown had that huge kickoff return that set him up for that rushing touchdown, which we saw, which led to the double ejection. And then Hamilton had a punt that ended up inside their own 30. But Frenchtown got a penalty there. It's Cole Ziegler, the man. He's down with the penalty. We hope he's okay.
Ziegler was the one who recovered the fumble. The Jackson Spencer catch earlier in the game, the hit that Brody Hardy got injured on, Cole Ziegler was the one to recover that fumble. So he's been a big part of this game, especially that play.
So Frenchtown's quarterback injured on a defensive hit. Hamilton, when he was playing defense, Hamilton's quarterback ejected. Connor Klimble, the sophomore for the Frenchtown Broncos. Second in goal from the 9. He's going to bring a man in motion. He's going to roll out to his right. He's looking. He'll throw, and it's going to be incomplete. That's about as far as my eyes can go down there, Max. It looks like he was looking for Carter. Oh, my fault. Tanner Waldron.
Tanner Waldron, yep. It was Waldron on the play, and that was a good rollout, and it was looked about on target, but clearly, you know, sometimes we'll actually get a great look at this one, and look at that wonderful replay on that as the ball kind of comes out, and a good pass deflection by Jackson Spencer, honestly.
Yeah, Spencer all over it. So third and goal from the 9. A 13-0 run for the Frenchtown Broncos. Connor Klimble, Waldron in motion. He's going to look out to his right. Kimble finds a guy. Flag. Caught. It's a touchdown in the stands.
And that was Dylan Warner on the catch.
Fishel picks up the flag. Let's look at the window. Klimble threw this one on a dot. Defense draped all over Max. I think this one's going to be PI on the defense. But last time I guessed a penalty, I was wrong in the worst way possible.
I'll tell you that.
We'll see what this is. Look at his third medium. There's our white hat. Pass interference. Defense. So I think they're gonna say it was defensive PI. It'll stand as a touchdown for Frenchtown. They're going for two to make this a one-score game. Klimble, three receivers split out left. He's gonna run forward. He'll be stopped. The Hamilton D-line answers back.
Honestly, you make that play. That is a good play call. Go for the two on those. It's tough that it didn't go, but you got to expect that with that pretty strong Hamilton front. But Frenchtown, what a turnaround for this team. 19-0 in the second half. This is the kind of stuff that you live for. When you're a high schooler and you see your team doing that, I mean, this just gets me pumped up.
19-0 run. All kicked off by Cole Johnson's kickoff return. They went down 29-0. And then since Johnson and Dowder were, I guess, tossed from the games, they're still on the sidelines, but they were ejected. They're not allowed to play in the game anymore. It's been a 13-0 run. It'll be interesting to see what Hamilton does on offense here, Max. They've had a few first downs, but an interception, couple high snaps, and that wasn't even a blocked punt. It was a fumbled punt, I guess, fumbled snap. He had trouble with the snap is what I'm trying to say.
Mm-hmm. And looks like there was a couple people coming in, coming out. I don't know if they were trying to confuse Frenchtown at all, but a little bit of a mix-up on the sideline for Hamilton.
1-3 bagels on the scoreboard, 10 minutes even. There's the kickoff for Frenchtown. This one's going to go out of bounds. Well, there's the break Hamilton maybe needed. Some bad field possession incorporated with some stingy Bronc defense. Max, Lant has not proved, I guess, backup quarterbacks. Probably not used to throwing, but he can throw the ball down. Frenchtown has been able to, he talks about a good pressure at the line, but like, why not blitz and anticipate the run?
Oh, yeah, exactly. And the thing with Lant, and Lynn is such a great athlete. It's really tough when you get put in a position where you're not typically throwing the ball, trying to anticipate this defense has clearly been very good at the run. When you're very good at running, it's always clashing, and clearly Frenchtown's been getting the better, but Lant might look to turn this one around. Got to hope for that if you're him, but we'll see here.
Lant, the backup QB, will hand it off to Frederick quickly. Frederick so fast, but once again there. Anticipating the run. Good defense by Frenchtown.
And Frenchtown wants us on defense. Their defense has really been a super underrated part of this second half. I mean, yes, they've been scoring. They've been getting points on the board, which is something they weren't able to do earlier on in the game. But this defense has really kept them in this second half. I mean, if Hamilton just kept scoring, it wouldn't matter. But you've got to throw love to those guys. They're doing a great job.
Second long. Lant takes the direct snap. He's got some space now to his right-hand side across the 45. Lucas Lant, the backup quarterback, I guess. He is the backup quarterback now on the roster. He's a senior listed at tight end. And he's going to run for a first down. And we saw when he came into the game on their first drive, he hurled a guy, Max. So the athleticism is there for Lucas Lant. He's walking backwards now a little bit, getting the play in. Kind of a no-huddle offense for this Hamilton team. Head coach Bryce Carver calling things out. Carver, I haven't seen a coach in disbelief like him. When Batter got ejected in a minute, he was kind of dang near on his knees on the sideline. But his guys are driving now. Lant, two running backs. He'll hand off to Frederick down the middle. And he'll get a couple yards. Max, Bronx are starting to go heavy.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. I mean, I think a big thing right now is trying to run the clock, trying to give the Frenchtown as little time as possible. And I mean, it seems to be working right now. They're at the 50. They had a really great run from Lant. So you've got to love that, trying to just play it strategically, honestly, is what you're going to do if you're Hamilton.
Yeah, only two receivers in. Two running backs on either side of the Lant. Frederick's on his right hip. Plenty of extra linemen now. Frenchtown going to blitz. A direct snap to Lant. He's trying to find his way, and this one's going to go for a loss. So Frenchtown not going to be tricked by anything. Max, I think maybe if you're Hamilton, third medium at this point, they're selling on the run. Maybe dial up some sort of trick play or deep pass. Just swing the momentum, because right now it's with the Bronx. Bronx of Frenchtown.
I agree. And honestly, I think it would be a disservice to Lant to not let him throw a little bit. I know that last pass was an interception, but you got to give that guy a bit of experience. You have the lead, and he can do it. You got to have trust in your guy under center. I think that's super crucial. And the less control you give that guy, the less chances you give him, it might not always go the direction that you want as a coach. You just got to have trust in your guys. Trust them.
By the way, as we get a whistle here, Lant, the backup quarterback, is Hamilton's team leader in tackles coming into this game. A good defensive player. He's a two-way guy. So Hamilton let the clock run it all the way and then takes a timeout. 7-0-8. And let's, Max, 29-0. Hamilton goes up 29-0. Let's just get a good replay of how we got there. So Lant comes in, interception. A trick play, deep pass down there, all the way down deep to the man, Dylan Warner. And then,
look at that. I mean, just a mess of grab on that, and Mawa, and look, Wimble, beautiful pass. Oh my goodness, just a dot. And this has been a comeback for the ages for Frenchtown, a team that really needs momentum in a super tough Southwest day. I mean, they're fighting one of those guys who's taken up those top three spots. So you have to play with everything. You have to play with gusto. And we were talking about it earlier. I'm going to keep saying it. Be creative. It's worked before. And just keep doing what you're doing, especially in the pass game. I really liked when they give Klimble those passes, especially that touchdown pass. Show him what you can do right there.
You just like to see the ball fly, Max.
I mean, I love it. I mean, if I were an OC, I would just throw the ball every play.
Air raid. All right, third and medium, 7:08 to go. Hamilton with the ball, looking to drain some more clock. Lant with protection. Now he's going to run. He's got space. He's tucking across the 50 all the way out of bounds for a first down. Lant, the backup quarterback, but he's still a senior, shows some poise and picks up a first down.
I want to give some flowers to Lant right now as we get a replay for it. I mean, doesn't see anything he likes and just tucks it and runs. I mean, that's just super smart play right there. Lant has, in the face of adversity, really come up and played really great football right now. So shout out to him.
Brady Schmill, the one who pushed him out of bounds. Now Lant going to take the direct snap. He's going to pause and then go out to his left before he's tackled. A good gain, about 9 yards. So now on the sideline, Bryce Guyver's like, hey, it's... Snap the ball to this Lant kid. He's a tight end after all. Let him look around. It looked like maybe trying to hand the ball off there a little bit, Max. And good read, takes it for a first down. Max, Frenchtown, we're talking about how big this is for them. They lost their first three games, two of them to Corvallis and Dillon. We're both still undefeated. One of those two teams is guaranteed to lose. As a quick handoff here to Frederick. He'll get first down yardage across the 30. Hamilton putting together a good drive. But here, Frenchtown, I mean, one of the two teams above you guaranteed to lose. Obviously, a win here would be huge in general. But for them, I think this is coming off of their first win of the season against Big Fork. It's a momentum game, and I think kind of making a statement to them, if anyone, themselves, of what they feel like they can do on the football field.
I completely agree. I mean, even when you have a record 1-3, it's really nice to have those big wins or even just close losses, especially, like you mentioned, Frenchtown is a young team, and that's great momentum for that next season, too.
Lant hands it off outside to Frederick. He's speeding ahead. He's still down to the 20, the 15, the 10. Walks the tightrope before he's pushed out of bounds.
And Frederick, who they've done a really great, Frenchtown has done a really great job of stopping him. Well, guess what? Frederick finally gets his chance at the second half for a long run and nearly scores it, pushed just out of bounds by Sear on that play.
Now it's going to be first to go. We talked about Frenchtown, obviously young team, first-year head coach. They only have 16 years on their roster. Shout out to my guy Zach Kaplan for that stat. But on the other end, Hamilton, they've shown a lot of poise and a lot of tenacity tonight. Lant, two running backs on either side. Play clock down to 15. They're really milking this clock. It's down to 5:36. Lant, a high snap to Frederick. He's going to bounce out to his left before he's swarmed right at the line of scrimmage by a few Frenchtown defenders. They're helping him up. Hey, you know, we saw things, a little fireworks, got a little chippy, Max. Good to see some sportsmanship on the back end of this ballgame.
I completely agree. I mean, we all get having rivals and we all get having rivalries, but honestly, it's really sweet to see that. And I think they understand that this game, you know, at the end of the day, it is football. And they have to remember that they're students at the end of the day. They're going to class and they've got to treat each other the same. And that's just really sweet. It's just really sweet to see those guys after a game that clearly has taken a toll on a lot of them, you know, come together and say, hey, we're just kids. We just got to be kids right now.
Second goal, clock under 5 minutes now and a timeout. Hamilton, Coach Carter, a bit of a veteran move. Let the clock go all the way, play clock go all the way down to zero before he called the timeout. Get as much time off this clock as he can. We talked about there's some tough bounces for Hamilton from within this, but good job by him to not let anything too crazy happen. As little time on the clock as can happen. And as we run this timeout, we'd like to remind you that coverage tonight's game is brought to you in part by the Montana Educators Credit Union, the MECU, since 1996, helping the people and communities that we serve. Thanks to MECU. And Max, yeah, we talked a lot about Frenchtown. A lot of resilience, though, from Hamilton head coach Bryce Carver. A Dillon Beaver, Montana Grizzly receiver, caught 41 passes, 9 touchdowns in his career. So it wasn't a bench warmer. He played for the Grizzlies. Sorry to interrupt you. He's a seventh year as head coach. that pays off, and I think it's kind of shown that he's been able to coach these guys even without his starting quarterback.
Exactly. And like you said, he's a receiver. He when you're a part of offenses and you're a part of pass plays, you kind of are used to, like, catching the ball. You can usually, even though it's tough without a guy who's passed first, get that guy warmed up like Lance to succeed.
Lance, second goal from the 90, takes the direct snap, bouncing outside of the 10, the 5, and pushed out of bounds. So good defense there by Frenchtown Brody. Is that Brody? Brody Hardy's back in. Now hold on a minute, Max. Frenchtown's QB went out with an injury, just made that tackle, so that'll be interesting in the next drive. But even better, they get the stop. It'll be third and goal. Pushed him out of bounds.
That's the definition of dog status. You get injured early, and you come back into the game. I mean, what a champion. Shout out to him for coming back.
Yeah, we'll see if he's going to play quarterback again now. Lant, third and goal. He's going to take another direct snap to his left, pushing forwards as he'll be tackled inside the 2. Fourth and goal from short. We're going to take a timeout now. So 29-19 lead here, Max. A field goal would make it still 2 possession. Frenchtown going to take their first timeout of the half of 2 left. Hamilton is down to 1 timeout. Fourth and 2. I mean, you put all the chips on black here, Max. Go for it. Obviously, if you turn over, Frenchtown's got a long field in front of them. 2 possession anyway.
And, I mean, yeah, you've got that as we got our next telecast on SWX, Jack. Sentinel at Big Sky Volleyball, 7 p.m. Thursday. I mean, that's a big deal. I mean, you're talking to Sentinel grad about that right now, so that's a big deal. I was actually around for 2 state volleyball championships at Sentinel, which is a really big deal. Shout out to that team, Serena Moreno, Elsa Godwin. A really great team, and when you're a freshman, sophomore in high school, you don't always realize what greatness looks like, but that's what it was.
Yeah, that'll be a great crosstown action. Volleyball here in the state, Western AA is getting competitive in volleyball. Just had Helena Crosstown live on TV here. As we get the play of the game. Fourth and goal from the 2. Backup quarterback Lant takes it to his left. He's going to run to the goal line, and he'll get in there. Touchdown, Hamilton! The Bronx with a surgical drive that ends in a Lucas Lant touchdown.
And that might just be it. I mean, 4 minutes, 25 seconds is a lot, but Hamilton needed that. They have really pushed this lead out as Lant will look at this play. Good blocks, gets some green grass, and goes. Wow. Lucas Lant.
Oh, sorry to interrupt you, Matt. Lucas Lant, great one. Brody Hardy just barely missed the tackle on the outside. Great effort. PAT will be up. Bend through. So now a 36-19 lead. Goes from a 10-point game to a 17-3-score lead. The Frenchtown Bronx, a 19-0 run. For Hamilton behind Lucas Lant, their backup quarterback, senior tight end, though. A great drive there to Max to kind of put the opposing Bronx at bay.
Oh, yeah. And like I said this earlier, Lucas Lant, applause to him for having some really great composure. This is not a position that he's used to playing. And even if he is, you know, throwing a couple balls in practice, you never expect to go in after your starter, especially, you know, when it's not injury. So you got to commend that kid for really hunkering down and doing a really great job. And now probably putting this game just out of reach. We'll have to see. But honestly, that was an amazing play. And Lucas Lant deserves, you know, all the flowers for that.
Still 4:25 to go. We've seen some surprises for Frenchtown. The good news is, Max, obviously we were on 2 backup quarterbacks. One of them has came back in the game on defense. The other one was ejected. He wasn't injured. So for the worst on both teams, For now, it seems like both guys will be back next week for their teams, depending on about enough to sit out as we get our kick return across the 20. Under the 35. We'll see. I mean, I'm not sure what the how it works. Tyson Bowder may have to take a game off. I know when coaches get ejected, they have to take a game out in basketball in the MHSA. So we'll see about that. But and also on the other end with Frenchtown's Cole Johnson. But for those guys' sake, good thing. Middle of the season, still got plenty of football left for both of their careers. So Frenchtown starting quarterback went down. That was in the form of Brody Hardy bringing their backup Klimble, and he's still in. So maybe someone, we'll see. We'll talk about that in a second. As Klimble air it out one-on-one, and this one's going to fly incomplete. Max, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure we saw a number 12 in there in defense for Frenchtown in the last defensive possession, right?
We did, but honestly, if you're a coach who's here, I mean, honestly, I would rest him. I mean, you're, especially in this position right now, you're down a little bit. I think you instill a little bit of confidence, give your backup some playing time and let Hardy rest. He did play a little bit of defense, but, you know, only playing him on one side of the ball gives him that rest.
Klimble, the backup QB before this game, had only thrown one pass. It was for a 38-yard touchdown in this game. He helped them lead a 19-0 comeback where he did throw a touchdown and didn't turn over. And he's going to throw an interception here. And it's going to be a pick six for Hamilton. Icing on the cake to put the rivals away. Tommy Bender to the crib. And Hamilton High School showing Selby some love down there. Pointing at the camera.
Oh, my goodness. Look at this beautiful replay. Klimble throws it, and there is Bender. Ben, don't break. Goes all the way in. Touchdown, Hamilton. And this student section went buck wild, much like the Bronx.
And it's Tommy Bender, don't break, if you're the Hamilton Bronx. 42-19 BAT. To make it 43-19. Hamilton Max went up 29-0. And then Frenchtown made it 29-19. At a point, they were looking for a two-point conversion where they could have made it a one-score game. Hamilton got the stop. They got the pick six like we just saw. They had that long rushing drive. And now with 4:05 left, basically slammed the door on Frenchtown.
And that's tough. It was amazing to watch Frenchtown do what they did, but congrats to Hamilton on being able to pull this one out and do what they did, especially on homecoming night. This crowd is amazing. The war drum is shaking our room right now, so you can feel it in the air. Hamilton mayhem. It's happening right now.
Yeah, homecoming to remember for sure. I'm sure there's going to be guys remember when there's that homecoming against Frenchtown, and two guys got ejected. And that pick six, Tommy Bender had that pick six in front of the student section.
And what a legendary name, Tommy Bender. Shout out to Tommy Bender. That's a great last name, buddy.
Short kick returned by Frenchtown across the 40. We saw a great return earlier in the game by Cole Johnson. He's not going to be able to return anymore after he was one of those two ejected. Student section, I got the phone flashlights out. They're singing, you know, it's good rally songs.
Exactly. And, I mean, what a beautiful night, too. It's a little chilly, but when you're cheering as much as these guys are and you're up, you're going to get a little sweaty, so you might be a little bit of a breeze under you.
Connor Klimble hands the ball off. It'll be a sweep to Corette, who's hit hard right at the line of scrimmage by Andrew Frederick, the running back. I haven't said his name on defense a whole lot, Max.
Yeah, I mean, you see that jump that he made? I mean, we'll get a look at this, and look at that.
Oh.
He hurdles as well as he made. Wow.
Whoa. They're getting their sky miles here in the Bitterroot.
Yes, sir.
Now it's sacking. The ball is on the turf. Frenchtown picks it up. But Connor Klimble, after that 19-0 run, dreams to nightmares for a second there. He had a pick six and now a fumble. And that's That's why they call it the blind side, Max.
Yeah, and
Andrew Burrows was the man who hit him. Sorry to bring
But that's, I mean, this Hamilton front, we've been talking about him all day. That was a great play. And honestly, at this point, it's really tough in terms of comebacks. So having plays like that to keep Hamilton energized and keep them on their toes, that was wonderful.
So third and long, Gibble going to drop back. It'll be pressured again. It'll air this one out. It's high, and it'll fall to the turf. Make it fourth and long. And now if you're Frenchtown, 2:46 left in the game, down 43-19, backup quarterback in. We'll see if they go for it or punt. They're going to bring some subs in and out, and looks like they bringing the punt formation.
And I think that's a good call.
By my count, they have 12 guys out there, but once again, I only had to take one math class in college. Oh, no, I called it. Look at that. There he goes. All right, they got 11 on the field now. There's the punt. We're Frenchtown, 4th and 10. This one's going to take another Frenchtown bounce. Punts have been good for the Bronx tonight. This one will rest right inside the 20. Hamilton going to get the ball back. I think that was for Frenchtown, the punt. Cole Houlihan. I don't know if he's last name. I don't know who Houlihan comes from. But that's a term and a way to rope something, actually. Rodeo term.
I mean, you know more than I do about the rodeo.
I need you to tell me a little more about the rodeo here, Max. Well, 43-19. Hamilton put up 43 tonight. Their offense has been great. Frenchtown, though, showed some tenacity tonight. They went on a 19-0 run. And they showed some spunk, but the Bronx will get it back. Two timeouts left for Frenchtown. 2:36 on the clock for Hamilton. Lant will come in. He's going to take a kneel here. They've kind of primarily ran out of this. This set with Lant, this has worked for the best for the Max. They've only had two receivers, an extra lineman, and two running backs. That's kind of been their bread and butter since Tyson Batter was ejected from the game.
And that's what you want to do. I mean, they have such a dynamic run game. I mean, you never want to know who that ball is going to, or you never want the defense to know who that ball is going to. So,
clock still rolling, just one under 2 minutes. Another kneel down for Lant to make it third and long. Hamilton student section, Max. I mean, they've been here all night. Obviously, a big win for them. It got fun, so there was a reason to stay there. And as we saw, plenty of emotion in the game for them to cheer for.
And looks like they're getting some popcorn bags down there, in addition to chanting, send them home, because they probably want to go home, too. It's a little cold out here as well. So
I think you forgot your coat, Max. I'm feeling pretty cozy up here.
I have. I clearly am not prepared.
Yeah. Well, 3rd and 20 now, 1:17. It looks like Frenchtown not going to call any of their two timeouts, so we'll take another knee. Wait, the ref's going to blow this one dead. Move it back, and now it'll be 4th and long. Game clock with 32 seconds left. Play clock with 27 now. Game clock 53. 4th and long, so there is about a 20-second difference between game clock and play clock. Obviously, with a 14-point lead. Wow, 24-point lead. We're going to go back to the math thing here again, Max.
And that's all right. That's all right. But honestly, back again to that, this Hamilton win, this is big for them. Coming back, having that happen.
And sorry to interrupt you, Max.
No.
Hamilton's going to take a quick little timeout here.
Exactly. They're going to take a timeout and rally. And, yeah.
So, it's been a great game so far. We'll have kind of full recap once this one goes final for you guys. But 43-19 for Hamilton in a game that did not disappoint down here in their beautiful stadium on the Bitterroot. Student section going to go celebrate their team after a homecoming victory. didn't come without fireworks, but Hamilton's offense, even on a night where their backup quarterback had to come in the second half, they still put up 43. Frenchtown puts up 19 on a 19-0 run with their backup quarterback, sophomore Connor Klimble, a guy to look out for. Looked pretty good tonight in doses. Has been good in small doses. So now, 4th and 23, 28 seconds left on the clock. Hamilton's punter is going to come in. So next, we're going to get another play. The last time Hamilton punted, it wasn't actually a punt. It got fumbled and was recovered by Frenchtown. This one, not a lot of space. So we'll see what happens. And Frenchtown's not going to bull rush it. So good sportsmanship by them. Across the 40, and it's going to be kneeled down. I think Frenchtown might have to come out and run one more play. Clock won't roll on the change of possession. But good sportsmanship by both teams, Max. Obviously, I feel like we went over it a million times. Two ejections in the game. It got heated. These two teams are close to each other. They're rivals. But good job by both coaches and both players to realize that, you know, the game itself is over. We don't need to be doing anything too crazy, injure anyone, get anyone else ejected.
No, I completely agree. I mean, a good rivalry needs to end friendly. I mean, these are kids at the end of the day just trying to have fun. And this is a fun game. This is a super fun game, and kids should really be proud of themselves. And Hamilton, that student section is proud of their football team right now for sure.
Connor Klimble, the backup quarterback, going to come in, and he'll hand it off one more time. And it's a fumble. The ball is loose, so we're not. This game's still fun. Hamilton going to get the fumble recovery. Well, now, Max, with 13 seconds left, because Hamilton just recovered the fumble, the clock's not going to roll, and they're going to have to come out and kneel the ball again.
And you know what? Frenchtown wanted to, you know, you want to run another play, and that's all right. But they'll switch possession. I mean, that's just another stat on the board for Hamilton. Get a fumble recovery, so.
I'm sure Bryce Carver doesn't mind the turnover differential. Is Lant, the backup quarterback, senior, also a tight end and a great defender, will come in to kneel this one away for the last time. So, in the Bitterroot, the score will go final 43-19. The Hamilton Bronx defeat the Frenchtown Bronx. Hamilton now 5-0 on the year, still on a burner. Frenchtown will drop to 1-3. We'll have highlights and a player of the game coming up next on SWX.
Discover the difference a family-owned Montana bank can make for you and your business. Stockman Bank is focused only on Montana, no place else. So you come first with us. Visit your neighborhood Stockman Bank to say hello and let us earn your trust and your business. Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking.
My name is Sky McGinty, and I'm the executive director of All Nations Health Center here in Missoula. We serve every single person who comes through our doors, offering Western medicine with an indigenous lens. Right now, our primary focus is to help folks navigate the re-enrollment process for Medicaid. Medicaid continuous eligibility is coming to an end, but that doesn't mean your benefits have to. Come visit us at All Nations Health Center to understand how we can help you re-enroll in Medicaid.
I'm Missoula attorney Eric Rasmussen, and I'm here to help. Please put my over 30 years of legal experience to work for you when you or a loved one is dealing with a serious personal injury. I am a certified member of the prestigious Trial Lawyer Million Dollar Advocates Forum, exclusively for lawyers who have won million dollar cases, and I have the highest A.V. Martindale Hubble rating. Go to my website or give me a call for a free consultation to see how I can help you pay your medical bills and help your family during difficult times.
Whatever the weather, elevation, or terrain, the Flathead never disappoints. Get there with Corwin Motors Kalispell. We're the ones on the corner with a bunch of vehicles in our lot. Sedans, SUVs, and of course, big trucks for hauling your toys all year round. Don't waste your time. Get the best price and the best service all in one place. Corwin, family driven for over 100 years.
Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Currently, C's can lease a new 2023 Silverado 1500 with the TurboMax engine for $449 a month with $29.95 due at signing.
Bye.
Well, the Hamilton Bronx advance to 5-0 on the year and defeat their rivals, the Frenchtown Bronx, in Class A play. Frenchtown drops down to 1-4. Our player of the game tonight, presented by Florence Ace Hardware, was Andrew Frederick. Max, tell me about what he did tonight.
I mean, there are two words to explain this guy: explosive and elusive. You look at a lot of these runs, gets around the block, is just a great presence on the field, and even in the second half, where Frenchtown was doing a good job of containing him, he still managed to get some really strong runs. And he's just a powerful guy. You gotta love it. Every run he does, it's just fun to watch. And look at this one right here, the one that was nearly a touchdown. I mean, Andrew Frederick, who got the first score of the game for him, and he was perfect all game. You gotta love that. So shout out to him, as we've got Jackson Spence right here catching the ball. And there's that Frederick play again, that first score, and you gotta love it.
All right, we'd like to thank our whole crew for joining us tonight. Once again, old Mickey Mano, Montana Matt, Stormin' Dave Norman, Wild Bill Heiselman, old Steady Hands Mason, Selby Delby, Big John, Shoeless Cody. Once again, I'm Jack Marshall, joined by Max Dupras. Max, it was great having you tonight. Until next time, this has been an SWX Sports production. We will see you soon.